canoeing competition in Paddles Up.
Hello and welcome to Nottingham for Heat 1 of Paddles Up. We're at the National Water Sports Centre this year for the BBC's International Canoeing Competition, where the best of men, women and juniors all meet together in the final for the Norwich Union Trophy. And last year, a junior won Paddles Up, so really anything can happen. What about this year? Well, through the series, I'm being joined by John Gosling, the former Great Britain slalom team manager. And John, the past 12 months since the last Paddles Up has been quite an exciting one for paddlers, hasn't it?
Well, it's been an incredible one. The Olympics took place in Barcelona. First time slalom has been in them since 1972. And performances by paddlers from around the world were outstanding, not least by our own Gareth Marriott, who won a silver medal in the C1 event, where he's kneeling in the boat and using a single-bladed paddle.
Now, to what extent are the Olympic paddlers represented in Paddles Up this year?
Well, we've got all three individual gold medalists, and that is a tremendous field to have. But apart from that, joining in Paddles Up, we've got the men and the ladies individual world champions. We have the junior world champion in men's kayak and C1. We have past champion Paul Radcliffe defending his Paddles Up title. And people like Richard Fox, four times world champion, three times Paddles Up champion. It's a tremendous field in every heat.
Well, today it's the first of the men's heats. Who's particularly worth keeping an eye on?
Well, we have Ferrazzi from Italy, the Olympic gold medalist in men's kayak. He also won the World Cup series in 1992, which proves that he is the number one men's kayak at the moment. We've got Gareth Marriott on his home water here, C1 paddler, but paddling home Pierpont, no one can touch him normally. So he is really in with a chance in this heat. We've got a past champion, Ian Raspin. He leads off the heat and is a tremendous force in Paddles Up. Ian Wiley from Ireland, he's the Irish champion. Melvin Jones from Great Britain, the new British champion. So it's a really strong field in this first heat.
So certainly a lot of well-known names. Let's have a look then at the full lineup in this first heat for the Norwich Union Trophy.
First of all, Ian Raspin from Great Britain, the 1989 Paddles Up champion and a member of the British Olympic team. From Dublin, Ian Wiley, the Irish champion and the winner of the 1992 pre-World Championships. Another from Great Britain, Melvin Jones, the British champion for 1992. On to the Italian national champion who came first in the pre-worlds, we welcome Renato De Monti. From France, Laurent Brissot, who achieved fifth place in the Olympics. Now the first of our Olympic medalists in the competition, a silver medal, came second as well in the World Cup, from Great Britain, Gareth Marriott. And finally, the Olympic and World Cup gold medalist from Italy, Pierpaolo Ferrazzi. And so, let's put the course and the paddlers to the test. Ian Raspin, age 25, from Great Britain, going into the River Trent, going round the first obstacle, which is a chicane between red and white posts. John, there's no penalty for hitting the post, but you really wouldn't want to, would you?
No, that's right. It's really bad. If he hits him, he damages his boat. The ball straight out of a net here. Very well done by Ian Raspin there. Throws it towards a boat there that he's thrown it towards. Now he'll just flick it in as he goes past, otherwise he'll get a penalty. And that's... oh, and he's missed it! He's picked up 5 seconds there now, and as he goes into the course proper now, onto the rapids and down to the artificial course.
Obviously decided to leave the ball where it is. Now he has to do the Eskimo roll. If any competitors don't succeed in the Eskimo roll, then they are disqualified. Now hitting a white ball, and then there are two yellow balls to hit. One high one, which he seems to have got, and a low one as well. He's coming round to get that low ball. And then watch for a red hanging ball, suspended on the left-hand side of the screen, just coming in. There you can see it. He's going up the red ball, and he successfully hit that as well.
That's right. So he's cleared that section there. He picks up the kite now, or put it in his teeth now, as he goes down through a traditional downstream slalom game, and has to deposit the kite now in a net. And everything he does wrong, he gets 5 seconds, but he's going very well now.
I wonder how many different ways of holding the kite we will see. So now he's going under a limbo. He's going backwards under that second limbo. Yeah, and now he has to pirouette or somehow hit the suspended pink buoy and going down to the final downstream gate with a time of 1:23.61 and 5 extra seconds for penalties. So we have a time to beat, and this is Ian Wiley, age 24, from Ireland. He markets computers, and he's a member of the Wildwater Kayak Club in Dublin. He was telling me last night that if he misses any of the suspended balls, he's going to be in for a major telling off back home. We'll see what happens. He comes now to pick up the football out of the net. There he goes. He's going to bat it down the river. No, he's not. He's going to carry it. On the spray deck, he goes down, and his next task is to put it into the raft.
Yeah, he did that very well, and he was very smooth around that little chicane system. Oh. That's OK. It went in, even though it bounced out. It was OK there. So now he comes down to the main fall, under the bridge there, and down to this roll, the sausage roll, as the paddlers have nicknamed it. It's very fast indeed there. Towards the white boy, hits it no problem. Now, can he get these double yellows? Because the top one, the high one, is very difficult indeed. Did that one, and he's missed the lower one, which is quite incredible. When Alan Edge designed this course, he thought it was a high one, they had problems.
So is he going to get a major telling off back home? Let's see. There's the red ball, he's going up for it, and he's got that as well. Well done to Ian Wiley as he comes down now for the quoit. He's collecting it. It's going to be another teeth job, I think, in his mouth. We've got to watch for teeth marks. Oh, dear. 5 penalty points there. He's hit that downstream gate, but now he deposits the quoit, and very successfully.
Yeah, he'll be upset about that 5 on a standard slalom gate, and now he comes to the limbo. Under the first, no problem at all. Towards the second. Now we'll drive at this by here and try and hit it with the front of the boat so he doesn't have to turn. Oh, and he does it very nicely indeed.
Straight down through the gate, the final time 1:23.55 with 5 extra seconds for penalties. So just and only just a new leader. Let's see now how Melvin Jones can do as he goes into the River Trent. He's 28 years old and comes from Nottingham. Used to live in the West Midlands, in fact. The British champion for 1992. He's been in Paddles Up every year since the beginning in 1983. He hasn't won yet, but he won his heat last year. So he must be hoping for great things. He's coming down now, picked up the ball and taking it over to the life raft.
Yeah, he's coming down now to deposit the raft and throws the ball in there. And you see there the sign, always wear Bynsey aids and helmets. You can see all these top paddlers. They might be the top in the world, but they still wear crash helmets and Bynsey aids for safety.
Because, of course, especially this is the bit where we go into the artificial part of the course. He's gone under the sausage roll, which isn't metal. It is, in fact, inflatable. Now he's battling there. Is he going to get that white... He's coming back. He's trying to get that white suspended boy. 5 seconds if he misses it. He's got it. That's excellent move. Really hard work powering back up that.
He's hit the lower one, but he's having real problems with these boys. But got both of them, so he's still clear as he comes down the course. Hits the red one, which is pretty simple. He won't be happy with that manoeuvre he's had to do there. But coming down now, concentrating, catch the kite, puts it in his mouth. Through what is should be a simple downstream gate to deposit the kite here in the net.
A bit of time lost on that, and speed is going to be all important on this part of the course. Coming to the first limbo, will he go forwards or backwards? What's the sort of style on this one, John? Some go forwards, some backwards.
Yeah, it's backwards on the first, forwards on the second, but Melvin went backwards on both, and he's experienced on that. Now he should hit this in one move, does it, and ends to the finish.
And down to the final gate, green poles go through them forwards at 1:29.77, and no extra seconds for penalties. Now, here's a man who is determined to enjoy himself on this. Watch for the smile on his face. It's Renato Di Monte, age 32, from Italy. He says he's just here for fun, really. Now, look at the style of his paddling. This is Canadian-style paddling. John, perhaps you can explain a little about that. It's kneeling up in the canoe, isn't it?
That's right. The kayak guys, they're sitting in the boats. Renato is kneeling in his boat using a single-bladed paddle, which at times will give him a hand, like there, and at times be a disadvantage. But now he'll just come down. He's going to throw it way at the raft and see if he can get it in there, and he's missed it. So now he's going to try, I would think, and just flick it back onto it. But he's been able to move the boat a lot faster. No, he's not. He's going to... Oh, yeah, he is.
He's going to go trying. Back. Now, will good it try. Land good try.
No, he bounced off the side, but now he's going down the four. He should be up very quickly. Canadians roll very quickly indeed. Down, he's spun there, hits the first one.
Of course, the advantage here is he is higher than the kayaks, so he can get the boys a little easier. Going around for that red one. There he goes. Now, we'll be coming down in a few moments to the limbo. Will John, will he find that easier because he's at higher up, but maybe more mobile?
That's right. Normally, the Canadians find it a lot harder. He'd had no problem with the kite. He can collect it. He can deposit it very quickly indeed as well. But now, with the limbos, he'll have a problem because he's so high in the boat. Now, we'll see what happens. He should lean back on both of them, I would say, a C1 paddler will.
Yeah, and just sort of sight, just got under it. Very good. Renato Di Monte from Italy coming up, has to just hit that pink boy, and now he comes to the final gate, and he's coming up with a good time, 1:26.99, but with 10 seconds for penalties. On the sea launch now is Laurent Brissot, age 26, from France. Very splashy entrance into the River Trent there. If you saw Paddles Up last year, you may recall his brother was in the competition last year, Manuel Brissot. Let's see how he does. 5th place in the Olympics for Laurent. So we're looking for a good time on this one. Knocks the football out. We don't seem to be having any problems knocking it out. It's a case of whether you can get it in the life raft, and indeed how you get it in the life raft. He's steering a little to the right there, so he's going to have to pull himself in, but very neatly popping it in. Now, remember, speed is all important on this. The speed will pick up now, but let's see how he's doing. 33 seconds at the moment.
Yeah, coming down now to the roll sequence, and he goes over, and he's struggling there, comes up, but the boat's on an angle. Hits the buoy there now, and he comes down to pick the two yellow ones, gets them both without too much hassle at all as he approaches the red one now. He's moving very well indeed, but Melvin Jones is the only other person at the moment to clear the course, and he was slower than Raspin and Wiley, so... Oh, and he's gone over, clutching the kite.
But at least he's keeping his speed going, but he's missed the gate altogether, John.
That's right, slalom penalty for us there, 50-second penalty for the body not going through the gate.
Well, Risso then went on to achieve an unfortunate total time of 2:24.36. Another Canadian-style paddler. From Great Britain, it's Gareth Marriott, age 22. Looks like he's trying to go in camouflage with that. Going round the first obstacle, which is the chicane, the metal posts, red and white posts. No penalties for hitting them, but you certainly wouldn't want to hit those metal posts. And John, he's coming round now for the football. That's the first real obstacle.
That's right, yeah. Gareth should smack this out quite hard. Yeah, it's moved out. Oh, and unfortunately bounced off his boat, but being a C1 paddler, he's been able to pull the ball round with the end of his blade. So now he's moving down. He'll be looking for a clean run because Gareth knows the name of the game in paddles up. It's fast and clean.
Yeah, and he got a silver medal in the Olympics, so he should be able to power down here fairly well. He's actually aiming for the 93 World Championships in Italy and the 96 Olympics, hopefully. Very successfully right the way around on that Eskimo roll. What do they call it, an Eskimo roll, John?
It's developed from the Eskimos when they used to fish, and obviously if they capsized out the boat, they'd die, but... That's where it comes from. He hits both of those. This is Gareth's home water, so he knows every inch of this water, like the back of his hand. He's wearing glasses there to stop any glare from the water coming up at him, because it's quite a nice day now. And through that gate, no real problems here for Gareth, as he hopefully deposits the kite there. And this is probably the difficult bit for him now with the limbos.
Let's see what the tactic's going to be. Leaning backwards on the first one and probably backwards on the second. Look at that. The wave's really helping Gareth Marriott through that. He comes up, nudges the boy and goes for the final gate at 1:22.40 with 5 seconds as penalties. This man, Pierpaolo Ferrazzi, age 27 from Italy, is a forest ranger. He goes into the River Trent now. There he goes. He is, of course, the Olympic gold medalist and a World Cup gold as well. And yet, in 1990, in paddles up, he went out in the first round, which he put down to missing a suspended buoy, so you never can tell.
No, he's coming down now. The pressure's on him because he is the Olympic and World Cup champion. He flicks the ball out there, and I know the Italians have been walking around as a little group and talking to each other, and he's coming down very nicely indeed, actually. He's moving the boat, and the leading time at the moment is Gareth Murray at the C1, so that's quite a first scalp there for Gareth as... He comes down to the roll now.
Guiding his boat very well. Goes under, should go right round. A slow roll, but he's kept up the speed as he went down, so no worries at all on that. Hits the first buoy, it's the yellow one. Watch for the white one. Watch for the two yellow buoys. Just there, the low one, and then the high one. And then he'll go across to the left-hand side of your picture and go up for that red buoy.
There he goes. Done all of them very nicely. This is all strange to these slalom paddlers, but they're using slalom skills all the time, so... They know what they're doing, and they know they can put the boats in the position. He collects the kite through the gate, no problem at all. Has to deposit the kite, get it out of his hand there.
Speed is fairly good. He's doing quite well. One of his interests is fast cars and fast canoes as well. Under the limbo, there he goes, backwards. And backwards on the second one.
Yeah, now if he can hit this, which Marriott missed on his run, he'll be looking very good here. Oh, and he's missed it as well.
Oh, that's a great shame because it's a good time. He's going through, he's going back for it, so he doesn't lose that 5 seconds. Was that a wise move? I doubt it. I really do. No, he's gone round and round again. What a shame for the Olympic gold and the World Cup gold. 1:34.97 with 5 seconds for penalties. And now at the end of the first half of the first heat, this is what it looks like. Gareth Marriott, Canadian-style paddler from Great Britain, 1:27.40, followed by Ian Wiley from Ireland at 1:28.55. And so close behind, Ian Raspin from Great Britain, 1:28.61. Melvin Jones from Great Britain, 1:29.77. And then it's Renato De Monte from Italy and the Olympic gold medalist Pierpaolo Ferrazzi from Italy, followed by Laurent Brisseau from France. But anything can happen now. It's the second half of the first heat. So let's start with Laurent Brisseau, who's trailing at the moment, and John, a new course for the second half of these heats.
Yeah, they're on the lower section now, and he has a red buoy to hit there. and then followed by a white boy. Now he has to paddle down towards a normal gait, and what you must remember is they haven't practiced, of course. See the normal slalom gait now, that'll be no problem to him at all. Cutting across and then a bell to ring in the stopper and then drives back out into the fast-flowing water.
And the next bit to get is a yellow suspended boy. He's managed that successfully down into the muncher, as it's called, John.
That's it, he's munching his boat up. Hits another bell there. Now he has to turn and it's in the slack eddy here that he goes down and has to paddle through the boy there and carry on down now to the tunnel towards the end.
Well, there's a little area here called the Magic Roundabout which they can get sucked into, but Laurent Brissot has managed it. He's going through the tunnel. That's three sets of two poles, six all together, and he's made it. So let's have a look at his final time. Up goes the paddle. It's 3:24.38 with no seconds for penalties. Now here's a man who'll want to do a better time than last time. Pierpaolo Ferrazzi, the Olympic gold medalist, goes through the upstream slalom gate, aim for the ball.
Looks as though he hit that and hit the white one very well indeed. These paddlers haven't been allowed on the course. I've seen a forerunner, so he's doing very well. Risso's running time was about 60 seconds, so it'd be interesting to see what happens. He's gone high into here now. And he loops out where the front of the boat goes down, so he's missed the bell and a big grin on his face.
A smile on his face all the same, which is nice to see. Unfortunately, 5 seconds added on because he missed the bell. He's hit the yellow ball, and now he has to go around for another bell. Is he going to get that one?
He missed that bell as well. I think now he's just having fun. He knows he's not going to get through to the final, but he's enjoying himself.
The paddle goes through the life belt, and now it's the tunnel. Now, there are six poles here.
Yeah, here he is, the world number one paddler, Olympic gold medalist, World Cup winner. He's the best paddler in the world, but unfortunately he's not going to get into the paddles up final.
It's just turned into a bit of fun for him, which is what it's about. 2 minutes, 34, 19, 10 seconds as a penalty. Renato De Monti from Italy is one of the two Canadian paddlers in this heat who will go through the final. One of them will. Unfortunately, he is trailing badly at the moment. Will he be able to pick up the time? He's hit the red suspended boy and the white one. And look at that power as he's pulling himself down. His body moving forward and just carving into the water.
Yeah, this is a good course, this section, for the C1s. He'll spin the boat here really fast and you should see him flick that bell. No problem at all. Look, crossbow there into the fast-flowing water. Going really well indeed. Look at this for skills.
And is he going to get caught in that, or is he going to pull himself out? He's pulling himself out. He's got that bell. Look at that. Nearly pulled the bell off altogether. Now down he goes for the life belt. And he has to put his paddle through that. Keeps moving. Look at that. A very deft move. Very successful. Pulling himself round and through the tunnel.
Yeah, lost a bit of time there, but moving fast through the tunnel. I think we'll see him sprint right the way down to throw his paddles over for the finish.
The final time for Renato De Monti of 2:27.10 with no extra seconds for penalties. Here's Melvin Jones, the first British paddler in the second half of this heat. And again, putting on a good speed, John. He's gone through that upstream gate, but what is he doing now?
He went too fast over to it, and he obviously had an idea in his head, and it hasn't quite paid off. But Melvin, this is his home water now. He lives in Nottingham, trains here, but he's moving on down quite fast, using his crank paddles, quite cranking the shaft that's supposed to help with the manoeuvres. He's done a spin, and he's picked up a five there on that gate. He won't be happy.
This is the problem, of course, with however well you know the water, you don't know these obstacles. Battling away. Oh, look at that. Battling away. Missed the bell. Another 5 seconds as a penalty. Now, he's hit the yellow ball, but this is a difficult one. This is what you called the muncher.
That's it, the muncher. Once they're in there, he munches them up. He's hit the other bell. He'll come to the paddles through. Melvin will not be happy with this run. Talking to him before, he had it all planned and thought he could still get in the final, but he's missed the tunnel there, so he's having to go back. He's in the magic roundabout, the swirling water down here. The paddlers call the magic roundabout, and he's having all sorts of problems.
What a great shame. Melvin Jones has been in paddles up every time since the beginning in 1983 and hasn't won yet. And he says usually he forgets to throw his paddle up in the air at the end. Let's see. He's got it up 2:42.01 and unfortunately an extra 10 seconds as penalties. We're now getting up to the leaders in this heat at the moment. Ian Raspin, aged 25, who could make it into the final if he pushes hard. And certainly, he looks like he's pushing hard. He's hit that red boy very nicely, and the yellow. Look at the grit determination on his face. Look at that.
Yeah, he's going down here. He's looking mean as he comes down. He's into this spin here. He's got the bell and he's out. And Kidder, his brother, was one of the designers of this second half of the course and taught the paddlers through it, and Ian was trying to get some information off him and couldn't, but he's going very, very well indeed, and looks as though he could win himself a place in the final if he keeps on like this.
He's not even got caught in the muncher either. Through the life belt, into the tunnel, one, two, there's the third one, straight through. Let's have a look at the times. He comes through the final, up goes the paddle, 2:11.51 with no penalty seconds. So Ian Wiley from Ireland has to beat that time to be absolutely certain of getting in the final. He's got into the final once before, although he's been in paddles up seven or eight times. He's doing well so far.
Yeah, he did that very well indeed. 2:11.51 to beat, which is Ian Raspin, because it's one men's kayak and the C1 goes through to the final from this heat. And with Gareth Marriott to come, he could take it too cautious here. Ian's doing very well, though. He did that nicely. If he can get past Muncher, he'll be on for a chance.
Now, is there a technique for how you go through? Do you go through straight or sideways?
Well, it's up to the paddlers. Really, you want to be as straight as possible, but he's hit the bell now. If he can get a clear line through this paddle, passing it through the life belt here, which he's done very well indeed. He's got to put the power on, though.
No loss of speed either. He's doing well. He's going through the tunnel, through the third one. He's slowed down. What a shame. Coming up to the end, up goes the paddle. We'll look for a final time for Ian Wiley. It's 2:17.75. No seconds for penalties. So Ian Raspin definitely in the final. What about Gareth Marriott, who led the first half of the heat? He's representing Great Britain. He's coming over and hitting that red boy and doing well on speed. Hitting the white boy backwards.
Yeah, he just went straight into the stopper wave and reversed straight out of it. Really good. Look at the way he's moving his boat. Both sides paddling. Now he should do a fast move here.
Of course, the height here gives him much more manoeuvrability,
doesn't
it? Yeah,
he just clipped the bell. He looked up to make sure that he had hit it then. And talking to him about the boy in the first run, he can't believe he missed it, but he's hit that yellow one as well now, so he's got caught in Muncher a bit, but he knows this water like the back of his hand. He shouldn't have any problems at all. Moves down 200 seconds. It doesn't look as though he'll win the heat, but he certainly knows he's paddling for the final.
Through the belt, and now onto the tunnel, through those three sets of poles. If he hits any of them, it's an extra 5 seconds. He's got through them all. He's coming up to the final line. Up goes the paddle. It's 2:13.57. No extra seconds for penalties. So at the end of this first heat, Ian Raspin from Great Britain goes through with 2:11.51, the fastest in the heat. Gareth Marriott from Great Britain also goes through as the fastest Canadian start, but also he was second in the heat anyway with 2:13.57. Whether Ian Wiley from Ireland will get through into the final depends on how fast paddlers are in other heats. We will see. Renato De Monte from Italy, he's missed the final at 2:27.10, followed by Pierpaolo Ferrazzi, the gold medalist from the Olympics, also from Italy, and he's out. Melvin Jones from Great Britain, 2:52.01, and Laurent Brissot from France at 3:24.38 also don't make it.
So at the end of our first paddles up this year, some surprises and some sad surprises as well. Pierpaolo Ferrazzi, the Olympic gold medalist, not in the final. What a shame. Must be a surprise to you, I imagine.
No, for me, this race is many problems, but I don't train for this race. It's in the first round, I have the problem for the ball. I don't push the ball for the canoeing. At the second round, I know very fast. But I like this course, but for me, it's very problem.
So it's very, very different from the canoeing you're used to and the canoeing that brought you a gold in the Olympics.
Yes, in this year, for me, the Olympic is the race much important, but I training before 4 years very fast for this appointment. I am very happy, but it's a gold medal for me. It's the best result. I think it's a good promise, but I'm paddling for, I think, another 4 years.
Well, well done anyway, and thanks very much for joining us. That's it for Paddles Up for today. Next time round, it's the other men's heat, so more thrills and spills in Nottingham. Join us then.
And that second heat in the competition is tomorrow morning at the same time, 10:35.
welcome back to Nottingham and the National Water Sports Centre on an artificial offshoot of the River Trent. Today we're going to put another batch of canoeists to the test. It's the men's second heat as they aim for the all-important Norwich Union Trophy. Well, we had some surprises in heat one. John Gosling, what did you think of the performances in the men's first heat?
Well, I think Gareth Marriott performed brilliantly. He came second in the heat, paddling his C1 where he's kneeling in his boat, home water, but that was a fantastic performance to be just 2 seconds behind Ian Raspin, the winner. That was really good paddling.
But we had some surprises and we lost an Olympic gold medalist.
Yeah, Ferrazzi from Italy just goes to prove that you might be the Olympic champion, you might be the World Cup champion, you might be the best paddler in the world today at men's kayak, but you don't qualify for the Paddles Up Championship.
To what extent are the skills required in Paddles Up different from traditional slalom canoeing?
Well, the skills, that they have to add skills. The traditional skills are used, manoeuvring the boat, keeping the boat flowing. But it's when they have to go and pick a kite up and paddle down and deposit it somewhere. Those are the additional skills. Eskimo rolling on a course, they do it if they have to, but they really, in Paddles Up, they have to do it as part of the course, otherwise they're out. And these are the things that are added to it, and the paddlers love to come to Paddles Up. It's one of those things. The field this year is fantastic because the paddlers want to come here and want to compete in Paddles Up.
So it's those little extra challenges that makes Paddles Up, well, dare I say, harder than the Olympics?
Perhaps not harder than the Olympics, the pressure's slightly different, but certainly more fun and enjoyable, and that's the whole thing. We've always said in the 9 years of Paddles Up, it's a fun thing that the paddlers come to and enjoy, and every year they enjoy it, and every year they come back for more.
All right, well, today it's the second men's heat. Now, who should we be looking for today?
Well, the defending champion, Paul Radcliffe, is in this heat. It'll be interesting to see how he paddles under the pressure of being the defending champion. It's his first big major event on TV as well. That's a lot of pressure on a young lad. You've got Sean Pearce, the current world individual men's kayak champion. He's from Britain as well, as is Richard Fox, 4 times world champion, 3 times Paddles Up champion. Those guys are going to be hard to beat.
What about the overseas contenders?
You've got Pollard from Czechoslovakia. He's the Olympic gold medalist in C1, paddling the same as Gareth Marriott, kneeling in the boat. He'll be out to perform as Marriott did and qualify in his heat and be up there with the men's kayak. You've got Lettmann from Germany, the flying German. He was a bronze medalist at the Olympics, and although he hasn't done much else in 92, he flies around the course and he's so impressive that he really could be a contender.
Well, as we know, anything, absolutely anything can happen. Let's now put the names to the faces and recap heat two for the Norwich Union Trophy.
First off will be Sean Pearce, the British champion for 1990, but the current world champion. Hailing from Slovenia, we welcome back Marian Strucko, an Olympic paddler with a silver from the pre-Olympics. Now the defending Paddles Up champion, Paul Radcliffe, who was a junior last year, took the competition by storm. Will success be his this time round? Simon Hočevar from Slovenia is new to Paddles Up, but he holds 3 Canadian-style canoeing championships, Junior World Slalom and Downriver. Great Britain's Richard Fox, 3 times winner of Paddles Up and 4 times world champion. Lukáš Pollard from Czechoslovakia, meanwhile, is our second Olympic gold medalist. And finally, the men's kayak bronze medalist from the 1992 Olympics, Germany's Jochen Lettmann. And so, launching us off into the River Trent today, Sean Pearce, aged 22, from Great Britain, the current world champion, just recently taken up mountain biking. Says it's good for your heart when you're canoeing as well. Goes round the first obstacle, which is the chicane going between those red and white metal posts. Picks up the ball, the football. He's going to knock it down, it seems. Bit of water polo here, John.
Yeah, that's it, yeah. Moves
on the spray deck.
And he has to deposit the ball into the raft. And anything he does wrong, he gets 5-second penalty. No problem there. So he's now going off the slack water and straight down the main chute into the artificial slalom course here.
And watch the speed. Watch the speed pick up here as he goes under that roll gate, which is actually inflatable, so no worries if you hit it, but they must turn right the way under. Here we go. There's the first ball. He's missed the first. Has he missed the first?
No. He hit the first ball there really quite lightly and does both of those very well indeed. There's 4 boys set up there. 1 white, 2 yellow, and hits the red without any problem at all. Now, shaking his head because it's quite cold, and now he's got to pick up this kite, put it in his teeth, and then paddles down through a standard slalom gate, green and white poles there, and deposits the kite in the net here.
So the green and white poles mean you go through. He's missed it. That's 5 seconds he's going to lose. He aims to get it in the net, but missed. He's going to come down for 2 limbos now. Now, watch this. He leans backwards. Sean Pearce leaning backwards on the first one, backwards on the second. Look at those waves.
Yeah, now he's got to hit this red boy with the boat. No problem at all as he moves down to the final gate.
The final gate coming up now. We have a time of 1:26 exactly with 5 seconds for penalties. Next, it's Marijan Štrukelj, age 27, from Slovenia. He's been in the final for the last 3 years. I think he went off slightly at the wrong angle there, John.
Yeah, he came down probably a little too fast into the water. But he's moving along now. There's no penalties if they hit these stakes, but I mean, they're damaged the boat more than anything. Moving quite well. The name of the game is to use the slalom skills that they have and keep the boat moving at all times. Hits the ball quite a long way here, puts it on the deck, and moving down quite well because he doesn't want to collect any penalties.
We have seen some difficulties on this life raft. It's large, but there is an inclination for people to think it's easier than it is and completely miss it when they're throwing the ball over. Onto the faster bit now, Marijan Štrukelj coming now. The Eskimo roll goes right underneath. The Eskimos themselves developed that so they didn't stay too cold under the water. Hits the first suspended boy, the white one. Watch for the two yellow boys.
Yeah, these are the difficult ones. One, two, very nicely indeed. And what you have to remember is, and it hits that, well done there, that these paddlers haven't had a practice on this course. They've seen a forerunner go down, but haven't been allowed on the water to try themselves.
So, of course, actually working out where the currents are and where the water's going to take you, well, you find out when you go down. Through that green gate, deposits the quoit and now goes on for the limbo. Which way is he going to lean, John?
Oh, he's going to go back. He's got to go back, and it's proving they're going back on both of them, actually. Yeah, it does that very nicely indeed. He looks as though he can beat Sean's time as long as he keeps clear.
Very good time. He's coming up to the final gate. We'll give you a final time as he goes through. It's Marijan Štrukelj. It's 1:24.60 and no extra seconds for penalties. This is Paul Ratcliffe, aged 18, from Great Britain, just preparing to go down the launch. There he goes. A bit of a job to get him, but he's off. Now, Paul Ratcliffe last year was a junior. He won his heat. He didn't just win his heat. He won paddles up altogether. And at that time, he was at Eccles Sixth Form College in Salford, and people kept coming up to him and saying, are you the guy on paddles up? And he was, and he won. He's the defending champion. But what a shame. He's already first moment in the water and he's losing valuable seconds.
Yeah, he flicked that expecting to happen what we've seen in the in heat one and so on, where the ball just bounces forward, but he won't let it get to him. Last year's paddles up gave him a lot of confidence. He was fourth at the pre-worlds in 92 at senior level, which was fantastic for his first major. But he comes down there to this roll gate, does it very nicely indeed. The pressure is really on him at this event here.
I know Paul does regard this course as more awkward than last year's course, which is out at the River Troer in Wales. He's missed the top yellow ball. That is a shame. He's picking up penalty points here. I think he'll be getting quite annoyed at himself at this moment.
Yeah, the concentration's there. He's got the look of Fox on him. His concentration when he's paddling is immense on his face. And he's back in now. He hasn't let it get to him. He's always missed the kite, so that's two fives he's picked up now. He's on 10 seconds. He can't afford any more penalties.
And this just shows how easily you can pick up extra time by just missing those obstacles or hitting the ones you're not meant to. There, he's managed that one successfully. Well, let's see what his final time is. As he goes through the gate, it's 1:22.44 with 10 seconds as penalties. Simon Hočevar from Slovenia tells me he's quietly confident about the course today, even though he looks like he nearly sank at that moment. As you can see, these metal posts, in fact, separate the River Trent from the start of the slalom course here in Nottingham.
That's right, yeah, and Simon here paddling C1. He's kneeling in his boat as opposed to the kayaks we've seen in this heat who are sitting in it, and he hits that, expecting it to go flying down the course, and he's having a problem as Paul did. Paul did the fastest run down the course, and you can see Simon here having real problems, kneeling in his boat. The Canadian class comes from the old Canadian canoes, the Red Indian, where they knelt in the boats using a single blade, and he's having a bit of trouble here sorting out that ball into the raft.
It really has added on a few extra seconds to his time. This is where the speed starts. Apparently they have a competition like this in Slovenia, so we'll see how successful he is. Under that inflatable pole, where he has to do the Eskimo roll, go right the way under and back, past that white suspended boy, the yellows, the two yellows, he's managed those, including that high one. Easier for the Canadians, John, to get the high ones, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, he changed grip on his paddles, which he's allowed to do as a Canadian. He just switched it over so it'd be easier. Now he comes down to get the kite, which shouldn't prove any problem at all to him coming down. You've got to remember, this lad is the junior world champion, so he's a junior competing against seniors in this class at the moment, but he's moving along very nicely now, and he's got his rhythm going.
And he's doing a fair speed as well. Under that first limbo, just the second one to do. He's gone out of the... He's missed it. That is 50 points, 50 seconds added to his time because he's missed that limbo. What a shame. He's going for that suspended pink boy, but to be honest, his time is going to be way off now. Let's have a look. Simon Hočevar, as he comes through the final pole, it's 1:38.56 plus 50 seconds for penalties. Now, if you caught John earlier referring to the look of Fox, this is who he was referring to. Richard Fox of Great Britain. Richard Fox, MBE, got that MBE in 1986 for services to sport. He's a former world champion, four times, in fact. He got fourth place in the Olympics. He's won paddles up three times. He spent last October canoeing down the Grand Canyon. Let's see how he does now.
Yeah, hits the ball out there and he's coming down very nicely. He'll be taking it nice and steady, although he's having problems. And he knows he's got to keep the course clear. This is Richard's home water here. He knows every inch of it, as we saw Gareth Marriott in Heat 1. Richard trains here all the time, and he just knows exactly what he's got to do. He'll keep it nice and clean and try and not get any penalties as he comes down. Hits the first buoy. He'll drive across the moving water here towards this stopper wave, which is the wave that turns back on itself. And I'm not sure whether he got that high one, but he's not going to go back for it. Fox moving along very neatly indeed.
Of course, what's worth pointing out is that although he trains here, John, it doesn't normally look like this, does it, with all these obstacles and quoits that you have to carry in your teeth or in your hand or wherever you choose to.
No, that's right. He's picked up a five. He did miss that buoy as it came down, so he's got 5 seconds penalties carrying down the course with him. But he's moving very neatly indeed, and he knows that he can turn the power on when he needs to.
Generally doing a fairly steady run. And of course, this is only the first half of the heat. Let's look at that final time as he comes through. For Richard Fox, it's 1 minute 20.92 with 5 seconds for penalties. Let's see now how an Olympic gold medalist can do. This is Lukáš Pollet, age 22, from Czechoslovakia. He's at university at the moment, studying paediatric medicine. 6-year course.
Yeah, coming down, working. The art is to keep the boat moving all the time, working all the time. And these Canadians really feel that they're at a slight disadvantage at times, but he did that tremendously well. Knocked the ball quite away, and now he's got it onto his deck, and he's got to keep moving. I think that's a mistake. I think he should have thrown the ball down the Canadian paddlers, but he's moving along. The Canadian class, the Czechoslovakians, are so good at it, and when this guy won the Olympics, I mean, he was just streaks ahead, really.
Certainly, I know Pollet is very much looking at this course as a bit of fun, hoping to win. I was saying to him, what do you find, what will you find difficult? And he said, collecting the football, doing the roll, collecting the ring. Basically, most of the bizarre things we get the paddlers to do on Paddles Up. There he goes, hitting that lower buoy. Missed the top buoy, though.
That's right, that top one. Alan Edge, who's designed this course, the national coach, the Olympic coach for the British team, thought that that would be a problem, and it's proving to be so. They come down there, he's got that kite, and he's goes through the gate without real any problem, and he's got to deposit it, which has been proven a bit of a problem to him, but did it all right there.
Let's go for the limbos, which are quite hard for the Canadian paddlers, Canadian-style paddlers, kneeling up in their canoes. He's going, oh, gosh, the water caught him there, nearly, but he seemed to manage it. He's hit the buoy with his paddle, and he's coming through to the final gate at 1:27.37 with 10 points as penalties. Representing Germany, the sales manager of a canoe shop near Düsseldorf, Jochen Lettmann, age 23. Now, he got bronze medal in the Olympics, so a very keen downhill skier. Goes to the Alps quite a lot. Let's see how he does as he comes round to pick up the football out of the net. Knocks it out, seems to have knocked it well down. Well down the course, picking it up in his right hand. Little bit of a fumble there, goes on the spray deck and brings it down to the life raft.
Yeah, he's doing very well. He's flicking it in there. The time on the left, that's Marianne Scruple's time to beat, 1:24.60, and that's for the first half. Remember, there's two halves to the heat, so anything can happen in the second half, but he's going very nicely indeed, but he's got to keep this boat moving.
Took a little bit of time doing the Eskimo roll, but came up quite successfully. Hits the white suspended buoy, the two yellow ones, the low one, and he's missed the high one. That's an extra 5 seconds he'll get for that. Successfully knocks the red buoy, though, with his paddle, and now he comes round to the coit, holding it in his hand. Some paddlers go for the teeth, John, some for the hand.
Yeah, I think the hand is probably the safest, but they feel happy. Oh, and he's having to... Oh, and he got rid of that just in time. He almost demolished the course.
I thought he was going to flick out backwards. Under the limbo, managed that. Second limbo, and just dips his head under it there. That's good.
Yeah, he needs to keep moving fast here, and he could go into the lead.
This looks very good. Let's have a look at the time. It's 1:16.89, 5 seconds of penalties and a new lead. And indeed, there he is in the lead, Jochen Lettmann from Germany, 1:21.89. Something like 3 seconds later, Marion Strugel from Slovenia, 1:24.60. Richard Fox from Great Britain, 1:25.92. Now we're going on to Sean Pearce, 5 seconds after that, 1:31. He's also Great Britain. Paul Ratcliffe from Great Britain comes in at fifth place for the moment. Lukáš Pollet from Czechoslovakia and Simon Hočevar from Slovenia. That's the lineup at the end of the first half of this heat. Let's have a look at the second half. Now, of course, Simon Hoceiwar was actually at last in the first half of the heat. We're going to the second half of the heat now, but as one of the two Canadian paddlers, he could actually make it to the final. We will see. He certainly set off successfully. He's hit the first two buoys, the suspended buoys, the red one and the white one.
Yeah, and he's coming down now. And on this second half of the heat, you'll see it's much different. There's a green-white pole here. And then he has to do a breakout and spin into an eddy. And there's the bell. He rings the bell to start this little section. He then hits another buoy that's on the muncher wave. This wave, a stopper that turns back on itself. And if he goes into that, he could get held. Did it very nicely. Hits the bell to get out of the muncher section. Now moves down and comes to this buoy that he has to... life belt that he has to pass his paddle through, no problem at all, and then heads down to this tunnel.
It certainly is a very, very fast section, this second half of the heat. It's going through the tunnel now. There are six poles, three sets of two. It hits any of them, it's 5 seconds, but he's got right the way through. Up goes the paddle. Total time of 3 minutes, 20.28 seconds with no penalties. And now the other Canadian-style paddler in this heat, Lukáš Pollet from Czechoslovakia, doing well, hitting that buoy with a great determination.
Yeah, he did that very well. Kneeling in the boat, they do have this extra reach, so he's doing... the obstacles aren't as bad for that style of paddler, but he's coming down now to the bell, spins into it, and he's got to lean. Oh, and he's in trouble. He's got to really fight to get to that bell. Oh, and he's over as well. He's having all sorts of problems, and the time he's got to beat is 3:22.8. To get into the final as the fastest C1 in this heat to join Gareth Marriott.
So, in fact, he's in a very, very good position, obviously not wanting to drop too much in the way of points and time, but basically if he can run a fairly steady course down, then Pollet will be in the final.
Yeah, but all too often we've seen him paddles up where people take it too steady on the second half of a run and blow the chances, but no problem there passing his paddle through. He's just got this tunnel with the 5 seconds on each gate, and he's going very well now towards the finish line.
Hit one of those, so there'll be 5 seconds there. Let's see how he does as Pollet comes up to the final. The paddle goes over on a time of 2:37.95, 15 seconds for penalties, and he's in the final. Young Paul Ratcliffe, 18-year-old from Great Britain, has a lot of pressure on him because he is, of course, the defending champion of paddles up. Didn't do a good time on the first half of the heat, and he's going to have to paddle very, very hard to pull himself up into the final. Doing well so far. He's hit the first two suspended buoys. He'll go through the downstream gate. The green and white poles mean you go downstream. And he pulls around now for the bell. Doesn't get caught in the stopper wave at all. And it's another bell he's aiming at now.
This is more like the Paul Ratcliffe we saw last year when he paddles up. He's much more relaxed. Talking to him between the first and second half, he was saying he was really nervous and he felt the pressure, but now he's moving really well and he's showing his skills. Look at him go down here now through the tunnel, and he's really moving.
That is a good second half to the heat. Up goes the paddle, 2:14.37 with no extra seconds for penalties. From Great Britain, Sean Pearce, who is 10 seconds behind the leader in the first half of the heat, so is going to have to push hard to get into the final. But again, doing well here, hit both the suspended buoys, and now down for that downstream gate.
We're seeing some real fast paddling here. Paul Ratcliffe went down in something like 40 seconds, which is an amazing time for the second half. So now, anyway, Sean's here, breaks out. Oh, and he's made a mistake. He looked at the bell and he's made a mistake. That is going to cost him dearly, a 5 second penalty as he comes over into Muncher, and he's got stuck slightly there now, pulls himself around, hits the bell, coming down to pass his paddles through, but he won't be happy that he's picked up a 5 second penalty already.
So 5 seconds anyway on his time, 2:08 he's running at the moment. This is Sean Pearce, he's passed his paddle through the life belt, he goes through the tunnel, hopefully no extra points on that, that's good. Up goes the paddle, over the top, a final time, 2:18.81 with 5 seconds extra. This is Richard Fox from Great Britain, who came in the first half of the heat in third place. Look at that power. He's obviously trying to pull himself up very, very hard into the final. He wants to get there.
Yeah, did very well there, spun the boat nicely. We'll see if Fox does one of his magic one-stroke breakouts as he comes down. He's eased off the power, trying to get the angle right, comes in. He'll try a spin here, look, goes in, hits the belt. Oh, look at that. Very nice indeed there, Richard. As he comes down now to the buoy, hits that, puts the power on the right-hand blade through Muncher, hits the bell, and now he's moving quite nicely, thank you. 156, 157, he's going to have to get a move on to beat Ratcliffe's time, though.
But let's face it, there must be other paddlers watching this or wondering how he does it. Oh, dear! He's going to be annoyed at that. He's going back for it. He's probably lost about 3 seconds going back for it, but at least he saved losing that five-second penalty. Through the tunnel he goes. He's got right the way through. Yes, he has. He's got to go up at about 2:18, 2:19, 2:18.33. No penalty points, but he doesn't make the final. Here is a paddler who stands a real chance of getting in the final. It's Marijan Strukel from Slovenia, who's a very powerful paddler. Now, last year, he came second in his heat, which got him into the final. Let's see how he does this time. He's doing well, isn't he, John?
Yeah, he certainly is. And this year, where we're using the two fastest losers, so six go through by right, and there's two fastest losers going through. So it hangs on right the way to the juniors event. But now he's doing very well. He hasn't picked up a penalty yet, and he's moving down towards Montreux. It hits that boy without any hassle at all. Caught up a little bit there, he won't be too happy, and has two attempts at the bell, but gets it. Now this is where Richard went wrong. Can he get his paddles through here safely?
Very easily, straight through. It just comes... went down. Oh, he's losing time. That's not good.
No,
He's now going to have to pull himself around for the tunnel, isn't he?
Yeah, very deep there, and he was doing deep supports, and he's blown it, I think, on that silly manoeuvre there.
He looks very disappointed, I'm sure he is. Up goes his paddle, 2:17.63, no points for penalties. Jochen Lettmann from Germany, a bronze medalist from the Olympics. He said he sees paddles up as a fun race. He says, I hope I'll be good, but we shall see. Well, he was first in the first half of the heat, and if he can keep this going, then he'll be in the final. But how's he doing, John? He seemed to have a bit of a spin there just before that second boy.
Yeah, I mean, he seemed to take it a bit too steady. I mean, the time 2:14.37, we mustn't forget, is Paul Ratcliffe's defending champion's time, who had a tremendous run down the second half, but he's doing very well now. Ratcliffe has the fastest loser's time at the moment, and therefore can stand a chance of getting in if Lettmann doesn't beat him, but he's doing very well, and he mustn't lose sight, but the time's ticking on here. He needs a clear pass through of his paddles.
As long as Lettmann keeps up a good, solid speed, he should be in. Look, well, this is good. Oh, he spun himself round. It's the wrong angle altogether.
Yeah, that magic roundabout section, but now he's moving down. Will he qualify? Is he going to win this heat?
Very, very close. Up goes the paddle. It's 2:11.17 with no seconds of penalties, and that means he's in the final. Now, what an interesting list we're looking at the end of the second heat. Jochen Lettmann from Germany was the fastest, 2:11.17. He goes into the final. Paul Ratcliffe from Great Britain at 2:14.37 and Marijan Strukel from Slovenia with 2:17.63 are the fastest losers at the moment. Those two could go into the final unless somebody else is faster than them. Richard Fox from Great Britain, 2:18.33. He doesn't make it. Sean Pierce from Great Britain is also out. Lukas Pollert, though, from Czechoslovakia with 2:52.95 will go into the final because he's the fastest Canadian-style canoeist from this heat. Simon Hochover, though, from Slovenia, he is out.
So the end of another day in Nottingham at the National Water Sports Centre. And let's run through what we know so far. Lettmann and Pollert are definitely through to the final. Ratcliffe and Strukel are in a strong position to get into the final, but it will depend on whether anybody else manages a better time in the heats ahead. Well, the men's heats are now over. In the next programme, we'll be bringing you the women's heat, but don't forget that the men, the women and the juniors all come together in the final. I hope you're enjoying the programmes, certainly the paddlers are, and don't forget, it all continues in the next edition of Paddles Up.
And that next edition is tomorrow at the same time.
We'll tell the world. Actually, I'd rather you didn't. You see, I'm one of your modest heroes.
Righto, Bigby. Mummy's the word.
The Homme de Banane, or should I say Banana Man, is back tomorrow morning on Children's BBC. What a lovely Bastille Day it's been, Quentin, don't you think? Oh, what are those people honking their horns at? Oh no, we're in front. I forgot, the car's on the wrong side of the road. It should be on the right side for France. Quentin, you could have told me there, couldn't you? Now, we're back tomorrow at 9:05. That includes Thundercats, Maggot Moments, Playdays, and loads more besides. So until then, au revoir, monsieur, au revoir, madame.
don't...
Dad's army's stalking the enemy.
Now, what we've got to do is to make the ram think that we're perfectly normal.
That's going to be a bit difficult.
You won't interfere, Mr. Absolutely necessary. Yes,
yes, I do believe you like butter.
What?
Don't be ridiculous.
A battle of wits for Dad's army. Classic comedy, Friday at 7 on BBC One.
No! Dad!
Cary Grant stars as a cockney drifter in BBC Two's film Now, tempted into a life of crime. Redemption seems out of reach in None But the Lonely Heart. International canoeing here on BBC One now. It's the ladies' turn to go paddles up.
Hello again from Nottingham. You join us for Heat 3 of the Norwich Union Trophy competition, and today it's the turn of the women to put their skills to the test. But before they do, let's have a look at the final and at what we know about who will be in it so far. We know that from Heat 1, Ian Raspin and Gareth Marriott are going to be there, and from Heat 2, Lukas Pollat and Jochen Lettmann. But this year, there's a bit of a twist to the rules, so there could be some others from the first two heats in the final. Now, the best person to explain the new rules is my fellow commentator, John Gosling.
Yeah, what we're doing this year is we're allowing the two fastest losers to get into the final. So that means, at the moment, Paul Radcliffe and Marianne Strutel are both in that position. Strutel just beating Ian Wiley from Ireland by 0.08 of a second, so it shows you how tight it is to get into this paddles up final.
So that actually means that we can now take some good paddlers from any of the heats, although they're not actually winners, into the final because they're good times.
That's right. The two fastest losers at the moment are both from Heat 2, which we said was probably the strongest heat. So therefore, those two boys now are sitting there waiting, hoping that no one in the ladies' heat and the juniors' heat beat their times, but it could well happen, because if we remember last year, Paul Radcliffe came from the junior heat to win the championship. So really, they're on tenterhooks.
So yeah, certainly keeps the tension going. Let's have a look at today, the women's heat. Who's worth watching today?
We've got Grosmaninova from Czechoslovakia. She was in last year's paddles up, and she didn't qualify for the final, and she was bitterly disappointed. She found the obstacles quite complicated last year. I think she's secretly been training back at home and training to see if she can get these obstacles better. She must be an outside chance. Lynn Simpson from Great Britain, winner of the pre-World Championships in 92. She's on form at the moment and paddling very well on her home water, as is Elisabeth Mittler, the current world champion and Olympic champion. Elisabeth is from Germany, but being engaged to Melvin Jones from Great Britain, she spends a lot of time training here in Nottingham, and therefore she's quite a home on the home pierpont course.
Well, what a lineup we've got then. Let's have a look at that lineup in detail then. This is the women's heat for the Norwich Union Trophy competition.
First today, Ulrika Åberg from Sweden, winner of the 1992 Swedish and Nordic Championships. From the British Olympic team, Lynn Simpson, who came first in the pre-worlds. With a creditable second place in the World Cup and a silver from the pre-Olympics, Czechoslovakia's Zdenka Grosmanová. A new competitor at paddles up, Marianne Agouillon from France, came fifth in the Olympics. But fourth place in the Olympics was taken by Eva Roth from Germany, who also came fifth place in the pre-worlds. And finally in this heat, women's world champion with an Olympic gold from Germany, Lisa Michela. And so off we go with Ulrika Åberg, aged 18, from Sweden. She goes to Stockholm University. She's one of two canoeists, in fact, in paddles up this year, who's studying economics, which, John, I imagine is quite a useful subject when you're spending a lot of time paddling.
Yeah, here she is. She's coming around the zigzag chicane system here. No penalties if she hits those metal stakes as such. She just damages her boat. And she hits the ball out. And this is the thing with the paddlers. All these paddlers try and find sponsors. Each nation supports them. Like in Britain, we have Sports Aid Foundation. But they find sponsors or whatever they can, usually the parents, to help them fund.
Because, of course, travelling around the world does cost money for these different competitions. Let's see how she does. She's coming into the... Now, this is the faster section, where if you watch under that inflatable roll, what we call the sausage roll, they have to do an Eskimo roll. And Ulrika Åberg has managed that very successfully. Now, she hits a white ball and then two yellow suspended balls. Watch for that. A low one, as she goes, and a high one, which I suspect she's missed. The judges will confirm that if she has missed it, it's an extra 5 seconds for penalties. But the red suspended boy, she's been very successful over that.
Yeah, she missed the top yellow one, but she's doing very well, and she's taking it cautiously. She's an experienced paddles up paddler, and she's coming down now. She's got this standard slalom gait. She's picked up the coin, pulls the boat through the stopper. Now she's got to deposit the quoit in the net.
Look at the look of determination on her face. She's not going too much for the speed, but certainly she's trying to get everything just right under the limbo. Leaning forward under the limbo.
Yeah, well, the girls, they're so much smaller, they can get away with it. Now, this will be hard. She's got to drive the boat hard enough now to try and hit this boy. No, she's failed that, and she goes on towards the finish.
So let's have a look at the final time for her. 1:37.99, 15 seconds for penalties. And here's our second economics student, concentrating hard. There she goes down the launch into the River Trent. It's Lynn Simpson, age 21 from Great Britain, who is a member of Hull and District Canoe Club, although now goes to Nottingham University.
Yeah, most of the British paddlers have moved down to Nottingham, the top paddlers, that is. And Lynn, real bubbly character in her own right. She's coming down here. She wants to do well in paddles up. She's determined to win the ladies' heat. And she's the only British representative in the ladies' heat this year, so she's really out to prove herself. And she's doing quite well there. She's collected the ball better than most of the men we saw in the previous two heats.
Lynn Simpson was in the Olympic team there. You noticed the ball go in and bounce out, but that will count. That will be right. Lynn was in the British Olympic team this year. Describes it as a fantastic experience, perhaps a little too early, so I'm sure she'll be back another year. Does the Eskimo roll, manages that, coming round sideways. That, of course, John, breaks the speed a little bit.
Yeah, it gives her more control as she approaches these two yellow boys and hits the first. Oh, and just manages to hit the high one, which she was most worried about before. Hits the red one now as she moves down towards the kite. The concentration there immense on her face.
Indeed, look at that. She's pulling herself round, up for that pink kite, going to hold it in her right hand and going down now through the downstream gate, the green and white poles that you have to go downstream through and into the... Oh, over the top of the net!
Too enthusiastic there. She'll be so upset about missing that because that was the easy part of the course for her.
Under the first limbo, comes up to the second. We have a time at the moment of 1:23, so it's looking good. And all she has to do now, Lynn Simpson, is to knock that big boy. She's done it. Down to the final gate. Let's have a look at a final time as she goes through. It's 1:33.16 with 5 seconds for penalty points. And we should hopefully see a good run from Zdenka Grosmanová from Czechoslovakia. Last year in paddles up, she led the first half of the heat, which is, of course, what she's on now. Then, in fact, in the second half, broke out rather too low and really lost the time. This is her second time in paddles up, so we'll see if Zdenka Grosmanová can pull into the final.
Yeah, I think she learned a lot from last year's event, and she's had a very good... two attempts at getting the ball out there. She approached it too fast, so now she's having to collect it and pick it up. Almost a kiss of death there by saying she learned a lot from last year. But she had a very good 92 season on the slalom circuit, and she's come to paddles up this year saying that she wants to win it.
But the right decision there to get that football, because she lost a couple of seconds doing it, but she'd have picked up a lot of penalty points if she hadn't. There's the Eskimo roll. She's going right over. She spent a little time in the water. I know she actually likes the Eskimo roll, one of the few paddlers who does.
Yeah, she's a great character, and she's coming down now. She's concentrating on this, and... Oh, and she misses the high one. Unfortunate there. She'll keep moving. Doesn't waste any time at all now. And she's a very small girl. Now, whether she has problems like Lynn Simpson in depositing the kite, I don't think she'll have problems collecting it.
Look at her face there as she came up to grab that quoit, and now she's pulling through that downstream gate, holding that canoe hard.
Yeah, the stopper wave there, the wave that turns back on itself, she sorted herself out, deposits it very nicely indeed. She should have no trouble with the limbos. Being such a little girl, she'll just flick under both of them. Look at that, no problem at all as she's pulling a boat through those big waves.
It all depends how the water gets her. She gets that second limbo, but she's gone through that, has to thwack the pink boy. There she goes, and to the final gate, we're on a time of 1:36.79 with 5 seconds for penalties. A completely new competitor for paddles up, age 26 from France, Marianne Agouillon, a member of Montpellier Canoe Club. Now, she was fifth in the Olympics, fourth in the World Cup. I think, John, we're hoping for a good run of her.
Yeah, she's because it is new to her, it will become a bit of a shock as she comes down the course, but she's got so much skill and technique that she should cope with all the hazards of paddles up. She comes to the ball and hits that, and it falls behind her, so she's in trouble already now. So she's going to have to either decide to throw the ball, put it on a spray deck and paddle down towards the raft.
It's worth pointing out that that ball is deliberately squashy, isn't it? It isn't that somebody's accidentally punctured it.
That's right, yeah, no, it's deliberately squashy so that it's more controllable for them, to be honest. Now she's coming off the slack water and onto the slalom course proper and down towards the sausage roll, as it's been called.
This is the bit where it gets fast. A boat hits the actual roll bar itself, but no worries, because it is actually an inflatable, so you can't do any damage to yourself on it. That first white boy, Marianne Agouillon, hitting that very successfully. The high yellow boy first, and then the low. That was the wrong way to do it. She's had to go upstream to get it, and she'll have lost seconds on that.
That's right, yeah, she got caught in the wave there. The stopper wave turning on itself holds the boat, and she'll be losing valuable time. She won't be pleased with that, but she's coming. The concentration, it's a fantastic shot here. All the paddlers, the look on their face as they get that quoit and decide whether to hold it in the mouth or take it, carry it in the hand. But she goes through the slalom gate now and has to come to deposit the quoit in the net.
More teeth marks on the quoit into the net. That's good. The net's actually quite a difficult angle to drop it into.
That's right, yeah. Now she's down to the two limbo gate, and then she has to drive the boat forward after she clears this to hit this big red void.
Watch this one. It's a good time, but really not quite fast enough. Successfully hit the boy, coming to the final gate, green and white, through she goes. She's still battling even to get there. 1:44.23 and 5 seconds as penalties. Aoife Raught, age 24, from Germany, launches herself into the River Trent. She has a great sense of humour and I'm sure is thoroughly going to enjoy this competition, but did comment it was a little bit windy and a little bit cold for the Eskimo roll, which she will have to do shortly. Anyway, gets round the chicane very successfully, the red and white metal pole separating River Trent from the main body of the course. Knocks the football out and knocks it nicely down the course. Now, if she can pick that up and hold it on her spray deck, then she'll be doing a good time. 24 seconds so far.
Yeah, the spray deck's there. It seals them into the boat so that when they do the Eskimo roll, the water isn't going to come in and the boat doesn't sink. So that's the idea of the spray deck thing, the skirt that goes around the cockpit area.
This looks like a nice time, coming down into the faster section, the Eskimo roll, where Aoife is going to get cold. No, she's stuck under for a moment. That will have slowed her down, and she's missed the first boy, the white boy.
What happened is she did the first roll-up. She caught the paddle on the sausage going across the river. So she's having all sorts of problems. She can't get herself back into it now.
Even smiling as she does it, but you can see that look on her face as she knows that, unfortunately, it's all going wrong. And it certainly did. Aoife Raught from Germany ended up with a total time of 2:03.55. Lisa Mickler, age 26, from Germany. Looking rather like a seal as she tries to get into the water. They actually call it a seal launch as she goes into the River Trent, don't they, John? Quite a challenge in itself.
Yeah, she slides down the ramp and then dives deep into the water and has to control the boat before she goes into this chicane system. And she's going round these large stakes in the river. And there's no penalty to hit them, but obviously she has to keep the boat flowing all the time.
Now, of course, she is the world champion herself. Olympic gold. I mean, a very good canoeist, Lisa.
Yes, she's the number one lady in the world.
In fact, comes from Augsburg, where the 1972 Olympics were. Been a keen canoeist for many, many years. There goes the football into the life raft. And somebody just securing it there. Right, now this is the fast section. Watch this as Lisa Mickler comes down, ready for the Eskimo roll, under that sausage, just knocks it with her paddle, which will slow her down slightly, but doesn't seem to have worried her. Up for the white boy. Remember, we've got two yellow boys. You can see them there. It should be the lower one first and then the top one. Looks to me like she's missed the top one. Judges will confirm that later. Up for the red boy. A bit of a battle there, and she's turned over. And she's over.
Yeah, she was in trouble there because she only had a blade in one hand, so it's a tremendous recovery from Lisa. The thing is, you've got to remember, she trains on this water as well because her fiancé... Oh, no! I mean, she's grinned and smiled as she missed that.
That's it. I mean, the competitors enjoy paddles up so much, which is nice to see. There's a competitive spirit, but there's a fun element. Even made an attempt to throw into the net the quoit she didn't have. That's Lisa Mickler for you.
Yeah, Mel Jones is on the bank, who was in heat one for the men, and Melvin's Lisa's fiancé from Britain. And he was really trying to coach her to do well in this, but she's keeping going and enjoying herself.
Which is the main thing about it. Let's see how she does. Lisa Mickler coming through at 1:42.58 and unfortunately 20 seconds as penalties. And what an exciting first half of that heat we have just seen. Lynn Simpson from Great Britain in the lead with 1:38.16. Zdenka Grosmanová from Czechoslovakia, 1:41.79. In third place, Marianne Agouillon from France, 1:49.23. Ulrika Åberg from Sweden, a little further behind, 1:52.99. And then over the 2 minute threshold, Lisa Mickler from Germany and Aoife Roth also from Germany. Let's have a look now at the second half of this heat. It's Aoife Roth from Germany. She just missed a medal in the Olympics, fourth place. Let's see how she does with the final. Doing fine on the red boy and the white boy, turning round, maybe not quite sure which direction she's going in.
That's right. These paddlers haven't been allowed on the water. They've seen a forerunner down, so it is very difficult. And now they're coming down. She's coming down to a standard slalom gate, green and white pole. Downstream, she can do it forward or backwards. She's broken out this side because she's got to get across to the other side of the river to hit a bell, which is positioned on a stopper.
Now, this is very difficult. Oh, that was interesting. She went round to it from the top, came through, almost got caught in the stopper, but got through. Now, the problem is she's got to get across for a boy across the other side, suspended boy, that yellow one. She's missed the yellow one on the right of the screen, hit the bell, though, and going straight through for the life belt. So she's picked up 5 points for missing the boy, goes through the life belt, and now into the tunnel.
That's it. Now she's going through a three-gate tunnel, a six-pole tunnel, and every pole is live, so 5 seconds. She's moved very well through that now. Oh, no, she's got caught in the slack water, and now she's got a paddle to put her paddles up over for the finish.
Aoife Roth from Germany with a final time. Here it comes, 3:06.56 with 10 seconds as penalties. So 3:16.56 for Lisa Mickler to beat in order to be certain of a place in the final. She's doing well. She's putting those paddles in. Oh, but she's missed the red boy. What a shame. No point in going back for that. It'd take far too long. So there's already 5 seconds on her time.
Yeah, she won't be happy. She's enjoying the event. I was speaking to her after the first half where she made a complete mess of it, as she put it, but she'll come down now, standard slalom gate, no real problem to her, and she's approaching this, as we've seen the men in the last two heats, more into the stopper there. She's got caught up a bit, so she's going to have problems.
A lot of strength required in this. Now, I would have thought her best bet is to leave it now. Yeah, to leave it. Yep, 5 seconds. Oh, she's smiling away. She knows she wasn't going to make it, but she's come down. Now, there's the boy, which Aoife Roth missed,
yeah,
suspended
she...
there.
She's going across Muncher here now, the stopper wave. It turns back on itself and holds it. Oh, and she just missed the bell. She'll be so upset. She's missing all these obstacles that she has to hit. Anyway, now she passes her paddles through and she'll come down to the tunnel, but she's got caught up in this little area here, the magic roundabout.
Oh, even Lisa looks a little sad now. Coming through the tunnel, not hit any of the poles. Yeah, she's hit one. She looks like she's hit two. She may well have picked up 10 seconds on that. Let's see a final time. And even her paddle doesn't quite make it. So there's the final time, 3:11.97 with 25 seconds as penalties. Now here's Ulrika Åberg from Sweden, who did a very good time in the first half, but unfortunately picked up 15 seconds of penalties and she's missed the first red boy. So there's another 5 seconds on her time.
Yeah, she just didn't go hard enough through that upstream gate, but she did very well in the first half, taking the scalps of the two German girls in the first half. So she's quite pleased with herself. She's gone through that downstream gate, very cautiously coming over to this bell now. She'll try and drive up through the stopper. And she was so close. She did so well there.
She really does look worried. She's taking it very carefully and, I don't know, maybe too carefully. She's got the yellow boy. Now she has to go over to the bell, but I'm afraid she seems to be getting caught on the right-hand side of the river. Moving across there for the bell. She'll reach up in a moment. If she gets it, she's having to come right the way around. It looks like she's some way off it, John.
I think she's sussed it out that if she takes it steady, though, she can at least beat people like Elizabeth Mittler, who is the Olympic and world champion. So she's coming down now to pass her paddles through. She'll take this fairly cautiously because the girls do worry about letting go of the paddles, as a lot of the men do.
Maybe she remembers well that last time she picked up a lot of time on getting the obstacles and the challenges wrong. Through the tunnel she goes. Possibility of picking up 10 points. No, she's fine. She's gone through that. Let's have a look for Ulrika Åberg. The time, 3:03.68 with 10 seconds of penalties, which gives us a new lead. This is Marianne Agouillon from France, age 26. Now, the top three paddlers in this heat only picked up 5 seconds in penalties each on the first half of the heat. So we're looking for a good, clean run. But unfortunately, she's missed that red boy. There's 5 seconds automatically.
Yeah, she did very well to recover from that. She only had a paddle in one hand and the determination on her face, it is so close to these top three paddlers in this ladies' heat. It's anyone's competition. So she's already now through the green, and now she's broke out very nicely. Oh, and she's gone over again.
You've really got to be able to reach out hard for that bell, haven't you? And make sure you don't go under. So she's lost time, she's lost points, she's going down sideways, she's trying for that yellow. She's way off the yellow boy. This is a great shame for Marianne Agouillon, who was hoping for so much. She's missed the bell as well.
Yeah, it was a good try, and she's... She won't be happy with it, but she's keeping going and she's passed the paddles through now, and she's got to keep driving through this fast-flowing water.
And of course, what we've got to remember is she did do well on the first half of the heat, so we'll see what the maths works out at in a minute. She's got through the tunnel, up goes the paddle, so a time of 2:45.64, 25 seconds for penalties, so for the moment, she's actually in the lead. Anything could happen now as we get to the top two women of the heat so far anyway. This is Zdenka Grosmanová from Czechoslovakia, moving for her first obstacle, the first challenge, the red boy, and she's missed it. Missed it altogether.
Yeah, she's copped the second one. She hit it very well there, the second one on the bounce back, but she didn't drive into the stopper hard enough. She's coming down now, puffing a bit, but approaching the slalom gate, which will be much more relaxing for her. She drives over now towards this bell. She's got to get close up to it. Oh, and she's buried the front of the boat and looped out where the boat comes shooting out backwards.
That took her straight down the river, so 5 seconds for not hitting the bell. She's now on what they call the muncher. It's eating her well and truly, isn't it, John?
Yeah, she's in trouble here. She tried hard on the first section. She's losing strength and she's completely the wrong side of the river now, so she's had to miss out the second bell, so she's picked up another penalty, passes a paddle through, but she's blowing the chances of getting into the final here.
And all she can do now is just try and get herself on course through the tunnel of the six poles, the three gates, and as she comes up, let's see what her final time is. It's 2:37.18 with 20 seconds as penalties. And finally, the fastest lady from the first half of the heat, Lynn Simpson from Great Britain, goes through that upstream gate and she's powering away. What a fascinating heat this is turning out to be, because she could do moderately well and still get into the final because she did so well on the first half.
Well, that's right, and this heat is proving to be and just show how difficult this course is. This Home Pierpont course, the home of the slalom team, basically, for Great Britain, is a really tough course, and Lynn knows it well. She trains here all the time and she's struggled to get the bell. She's missed the bell. She moves on over to the boy. She's doing very well. She'll know roughly what she's got to do to get through to the final, but she's got caught in the stopper. She's ridden that very well indeed. She's got to pull out, gets the second bell. She's going very well indeed now as she moves down. Get your paddles through, Lynn. Come on.
She's got a little bit of time to play with because she did so well first time round. The paddle goes through the life belt, and there she is pulling herself round through the tunnel. She's lost time. She's going to have to go right the way round again. That's going to add about 10 seconds on her time.
Well, yeah, the magic roundabout causes a problem again now as Lynn comes across. She's driving down. She's through. Lost one pole to go. She's got to get her paddles over at the finish.
She's still looking good, though. Up her paddle goes. 2:40.61. 5 seconds of penalties, and Lynn Simpson is in the final. So at the end of the women's heat then, Lynn Simpson from Great Britain goes through to the final with 2:45.61, and the others don't make it. Zdenka Grosmanová from Czechoslovakia, she's out, as is Marianne Agouillon from France. Ulrika Åberg from Sweden and Eva Roth from Germany are out, and so is the gold medalist from the Olympics, Lisa Mickler from Germany. She didn't make it to the final in this year's Paddles Up.
Well, one person, as we saw there, who unfortunately won't make it through to the final is the Olympic gold medalist, Lisa Mickler. Lisa, I imagine you must be a little bit disappointed.
Yeah, it's always disappointing when you don't make the final. C'est la vie.
I suppose overall there's an element of fun to it as well.
Yeah, it is. It's a bit different what we normally do on racing, and it's the end of the season, but it's fun, yeah.
What do you think actually went wrong, really?
Well, I think because I have problems with hitting the targets with the balls, and because I'm a small person, and so it went wrong from the first run, say, where I had to hit the balls, I fell in and screwed up there the time. And
perhaps you can just take us through that run from when you first went in the water. That's the slow section to start with.
Right, okay. Through the dance. Then the slide was okay, then the S moves, and then pick up the ball into the raft, the roll, that was okay, but then I had problems with these balls to hit, and I fell in to hit the red ball, and I had to pick up the hoop, and couldn't reach the hoop, so couldn't deliver it, so I got their penalties as well, and didn't got the ball as well down by the pyramid, and so I had 25 seconds added. Plus my time, and it wasn't very good. It's hard to reach for
a little bit taller and you'd have been all right.
Yeah.
But anyway, you enjoyed doing it even if you didn't make it through.
Yeah, I enjoy. It's good, it's great fun, yeah.
Well, thanks very much for coming along. Thanks very much for participating. Yeah. That's the women's heat then. The next heat we'll be showing you on Paddles Up is the junior heat. Now, remember that last year, the overall winner of Paddles Up came from the juniors, so anything can happen. Don't miss it.
And you can see the junior heat tomorrow, 10:35, here on BBC One.
Welcome back to Nottingham and the National Water Sports Centre on the banks of the River Trent for Heat 4 of Paddles Up. And in fact, it's the last heat today in the competition for the Norwich Union Trophy. It's the turn of the juniors, but as John Gosling was reminding me earlier, we really mustn't underestimate their potential.
Certainly not. Last year, the winner, Paul Radcliffe, came from the juniors. He's here today watching because he's clinging on to the fastest loser's position at the moment to get through to the final. But it's great to see most of the senior paddlers are here watching and helping and supporting these junior paddlers. And it's probably the most exciting heat of all four.
Now, we know who the winners are of the first three heats who will be in the final. But, I mean, we've got Paul Radcliffe and Marianne Struckel hanging on for the fastest losers' positions. Now, is there any chance that the juniors could displace them, could actually have a faster time?
There certainly is. I mean, the juniors fly down this course, as the seniors do, and they're as powerful as the men. And they really have a chance. I mean, if I just tell you that James Croft, who's the junior world champion, has had his father looking at past videos of Paddles Up to see where mistakes are made, and he's going away and mentally preparing for this event. That is tremendous enthusiasm.
So James Croft, a good one to look for. Anybody else just to bear in mind? One other thought?
O'Toole from Ireland could be an outsider. It's his first ever Paddles Up. But Ian Wiley, who is his coach, who was in the men's heat, he's really trying to get one of his boys through to the final. He could just be an outsider because he's fairly powerful and a really nice lad.
So the message out of that is obviously to hang on for the next 25 minutes and watch the thrills and spills of this last heat, the juniors. Let's have a look at the full lineup.
Starting the juniors off will be a new competitor for Paddles Up, the Irish junior champion Keith O'Toole. Next, Italy's Matteo Pontarolo, the junior Italian champion for 1992. From Czechoslovakia, we welcome back Wojciech Bareš, holder of the bronze medal from the 1991 Junior Pre-World Championships. The first British junior competitor will be Leo Hoare, who came fourth in the Junior World Championship. Dejan Kral from Slovenia is the youngest competitor, aged 16. He was second in the Junior World Championships. And the final competitor, James Croft from Great Britain, the Junior World Champion. And so off we go. Keith O'Toole from Ireland starting us off. He lives in Dublin. Does the seal launch into the water there. If you get that launch at the wrong angle, John, you're off all over the place, down the River Trent and goodness knows where.
That's right, yeah. They've got to control it and they've got to keep the boat moving when it hits the water. But he did very well there and ran the chicane section. And it's Keith's first ever Paddles Up, so it's new to him. He hits the ball out and hits it very well indeed, right out to the middle. And is he going to do the back polo system by throwing the ball and going after it?
Seems to be having a polo match all on his own here. Bringing it back, though, to the life raft. Whether that will count, I don't know. We'll get a word from the judge in a moment on that one. Yes, apparently it will count. So not picked up penalty points, but rather too much time.
That's right. Now he's into the slalom course, and he does the Eskimo roll there and has a bit of problems under what the paddlers have called the sausage roll, and he hits the first boy, and there's four boys down here. The white one, now two yellow ones, one lower, one higher. Low one easy, and I don't think he hit the high one there. I think he hit the one against it, but hits the red one there at the end. He's picked up 5 seconds as he comes on down now to collect in his kite.
Although this is the first time Keith has been in Paddles Up, has he missed the kite? He's missed the kite. Now, that's going to be a shame, because obviously now, as a net comes up, what he's meant to do is deposit the kite.
That's right.
But obviously so he can't.
He's picked up 10 seconds worth of penalties, and although he's saved a bit of time, I suppose, it's really not about saving time. It's about keeping clear.
Leaning forward on both the limbos. And now Keith coming round for the pink suspended boy. It's a large one, but he's missed that as well. That's a great shame. Let's see what his final time is. 1:28.68 and 20 seconds for penalties. Contestant number two in this junior heat is Matteo Pontarolo. He's 18 years old, from Italy. He's the junior Italian champion for 1992. What a speed, what a speed.
Yeah, when he came down the slide, he angled the boat so that he really didn't dive deep. And he's going very well indeed. And The big thing about Paddles Up is the senior paddlers come along to help the juniors, and there's been two Italians in the senior heat, so they're here helping this boy down. They want their junior boy to win.
And of course, remember that last year we had an overall winner, Paul Ratcliffe, from Paddles Up, who was in the juniors. Look at this speed. He's coming down now. This is the bit where he will pick up speed as Matteo Pontarolo comes for the Eskimo roll and goes under. Loses no time on that.
No, very impressive indeed. This boy looks really good. It's the first time I've seen him paddle. He was seventh at the Junior Worlds in Norway, and oh, he's missed that high one. He's got to now keep his cool and go, but he's going to go back for it, and this is where he could waste time if he's not careful.
That was unfortunately the wrong decision. I mean, it's easier to sit here and say that, but he's lost 5 seconds for not hitting it, and also the time he tried to get it.
No, he actually hit it when he went back. It's just that he's lost the time, so really and truthfully, he sort of lost and he won. But anyway, he's got the quoit now. He's through the gate. He's on his way down. Can he deposit his quoit in this net? Yes, so he's just got to move down to the limbos now, Michael.
Let's have a look at the limbos. Matteo Pontarolo will lean forward as he goes under the first one, and he's angling himself up now for that second limbo gate. There he goes.
Tremendous there. Now, if he can hit this boy, which he's hit now, he's moving down to the finish. This is really quite a fast time.
This is an excellent time. The finishing gate, he goes through at 1:32.71 with no extra seconds as penalties. Into the water goes Wojciech Bareš, aged 18, from Czechoslovakia. He goes to university at the moment in Prague, in fact, where he's doing civil engineering. Going round through that first chicane, avoiding those metal poles, as you have to. Now, last year, he missed the boys, the hanging boys. He also missed the quoit, but he's going for the football now and has knocked that out. With a bit of luck, we'll pick it up, put it on his spray deck, there we go, and going down to the life raft.
Yeah, he's doing very well. The Czechoslovakians, I'm sure, have been training for this. They enjoy Paddles Up. It's relief for them instead of just constant slalom training.
That's very interesting, because Wojciech claims he hasn't been practicing, but we'll see how he does. Coming down into the faster section now, you'll notice him pick up speed. He goes for the Eskimo roll under the what's called the sausage roll and succeeds in that.
Hits the boy now as he's coming down, then goes back. He's ferry gliding, which is angling the boat across stream with the fast flowing, trying to get both, and he gets the high one and misses the low one. But he's not letting it affect him. He's moving on down now towards the kite. Concentration on his face as he goes to collect the kite here.
There he goes, nearly overbalances. He's pushing down hard on that left-hand side. Now into the water, a lot faster water there, through the downstream gate, and should deposit that kite very successfully.
There, did that very nicely indeed. Trying to control the speed of the boat now as he approaches the limbos. He's quite a big lad, so he leans back for the first, leans back for the second.
Now, what's the technique on this one?
It's to drive at the buoy and lean back on the boat.
We've seen a number of different ways. Let's have a look at that time. 1:25.86, 10 seconds for penalties. Leo Hoare, aged 18, from Great Britain, having now swapped his multicoloured hat for a crash helmet, and very wisely too, goes into the first challenge. The chicane just goes round those metal posts. No penalties if he hits them, but you wouldn't want to because of the damage it would do to your boat. Probably knock you out as well. Knock you out of the water. Let's have a look. Coming up to the football. Knocks that out. Playing basketball, I think, today.
Yeah, he was trying to craft it there by flicking the ball out and hopefully picking it up as he went. But he's got the ball now and he's moving on down. And Leo had a very respectable fourth at the Junior Worlds. He'd be unhappy with it because he wanted a medal. But he did very well indeed.
Pulling down hard now. A lot of power going into those strokes. But just judging that sausage roll, as we call it, well, and he's pulled round very quickly. Some paddlers go one way, some the other.
That's right, yeah, it's just which way you're most confident with, really, and you feel happiest with. But he's hit the first, and oh, I think he clipped the second, but he's gone over in the attempt, and now he's going to waste time rolling up. He won't be pleased with that at all.
And it disorientates you as well, doesn't it? When you go under, you come up, and you're not quite sure which way around you're looking.
Yeah, I mean, it's really cold here today. The water's very cold, as we've seen in all the heats. It affects the paddlers with the roll, and to do an extra one is really hard. He's clear up to now, though. He managed to get that second one. He picks up the kite, moving down, puffing. His hair's come down out of his crash helmet, so he can hardly see where he's going, I think, on the right-hand side.
Talk of disorientation. Anyway, he's dropped the kite in the net. Now it's the limbo where he will lean. He's going backwards, lining himself up the second limbo, backwards again.
Drives now at this boy now. He should get this in one move, yeah. Just clipped it, I think, and he's on his way down for a clear run.
Let's have a look at the final time. 1:33.19 and no seconds for penalties. Now, this is our youngest competitor in Paddles Up this year, Dejan Kral from Slovenia, age 16. Does a little bit of a twist as he goes down that seal launch into the River Trent. But look at that speed as he goes around the holes. and goes eventually for the football. He's doing well there, John.
Yeah, he certainly is. These juniors really want to get into the final to compete with the senior boys to show them up, as Paul did last year, really. Oh, and he's having problems. He's got the ball out of second attempt and caught it brilliantly.
Thought he was going to head it into the life draft there. Again, look at that speed. Pushing hard, coming up onto the right-hand side of the life draft. Tosses it in. It's even stayed in as well. And down onto the faster part of the course.
That's right, yeah. Now, going down now into the roll section and onto the actual artificial course. It's very important for these junior paddlers to know this water. Oh, and he's having troubles there as he approaches the kite.
He spent a long time under on his Eskimo roll and had problems pulling out it, but he has hit that white boy. Look for the two yellow ones, the suspended boys, the low one and the high one. Not sure if he's got that one or not, the high one.
It's looking like he might have a penalty on it, yes. I think he got a penalty on the yellow one. But
so 5 extra seconds there.
That's right. But as I was going to say, this is the 1995 World Championship course, so site for the World Championships. And these paddlers will all be hoping to compete there. And he'll want to learn the water. And competitions like Paddles Up is the greatest way to learn water.
So the coit is in the net. And he's coming to the limbo, leaning back. The time 1:23, 1:24. He's on a fairly good time.
But he's now in the wrong position to go and hit this one. But he's driven down very well indeed and called himself back.
Maneuvered himself round. The time 1:34.03 plus 5 seconds for penalties. Let's see if Matteo Pontarolo's lead can be broken now by James Croft, the final competitor, 18 years old from Great Britain. He's planning to do sports studies when he leaves school. Member of Stevenage Canoe Club. And he's doing well as well. A lot of power there.
Yeah, remember, he got into the final last year and and he almost demolishes the course, but I suppose he's the last one on, so he can do it.
Just going for the tennis version here, knocking it down with his paddles.
Yeah, going very nice indeed now. Throws that in. And James is the junior world champion, which he won in 1992 in Norway. And he's powering on down here. Reverse roll there and up quite quickly and holds his boat still, so he's going to be in more control to approach the boys. Hits the white one. Now the two yellow ones. If he can get these in one move, this is a really good run. Oh,
yes.
Excellent.
Yes, very good. We have seen a few paddlers over the week actually doing that. And he's managed to... Oh, he's going around for that red. He's missed the red. That's going to be 5 seconds, but he's doing a good time. 52 seconds. He picks up the coit. Very determined. Very straight into his mouth. Gripping it there through the downstream gate. Let's have a look. He's going to take it out. He's going to drop it into the net. Very smoothly. Lovely speed.
Yeah, now he's moving out to the two limbos. Keeps the boat moving along. Wants to be clear. Has to be clear. Oh, and he's in trouble approaching the second limbo, but does it nicely. Drives on now to hit the boy. Does it brilliantly as he ends for the finish.
This is a superb time. It's 1 minute and 17.88 seconds plus 5 seconds for penalties. And so there he is, heading up the first half of this junior heat. James Croft from Great Britain, 1:22.88. A whole 10 seconds in front of Matteo Pontarolo from Italy, 1:32. Leo Hoare from Great Britain is at 1:33.19, followed by Wojciech Baras from Czechoslovakia, Dejan Kral from Slovenia, and Keith O'Toole from Ireland. That's what it looks like at the moment. Let's take a look at the second half of the junior heat. And so to the bottom paddler on that list, Keith O'Toole from Ireland, who trains twice a day, and in fact his coach is Ian Wiley, who's also in this competition. He's missed the first boy. There's 5 seconds going to add to his time automatically there.
Yeah, they can't really afford penalties, I don't think. He didn't have that good a first half, but it's his first paddles up, and the determination on his face. This bottom section should be easier for him because it's more slalom, it's on fast-flowing water. The moves are in stoppers and on the backs of waves, so he should do all right now.
In fact, a couple of days before we started this competition, Keith didn't even know he was going to be in it. So I think he's doing well, considering what he's having to adjust to. This isn't what canoeists are used to.
That's right, and you can see he's come down now. He's got to pass his paddles through. This is nothing like that in the first half, where he passed his paddles through. And this is the tunnel. 6 gates, every gate live, every pole, so there's possible 30 penalties there as he comes down now to the usual paddles up finish.
So let's see what time Keith O'Toole can set for the juniors. 2:41.51 with 5 seconds for penalties. 2:46.51 for Dejan Kral to beat at this stage, but only the second competitor to go into the second half of the junior heat. Look at that. Hits the boy very successfully. No problems. He's going well. He is.
He's moving on well downstream now. He's hit the first two boys, so now he's down to the normal green and white slalom gate. Going downstream, goes through that, forwards or backwards, it doesn't matter. Breaks out.
Yeah, this is the bit where they can get caught. He hasn't got caught, but I'm not sure he hit the bell.
No, I think he did. I'm sure he hit the bell there. Hit the boy. Now he's got to drive back through Muncher. That big stopper wave there. Made a mistake, but he isn't low enough down. He's got the power. Young lad, but very powerful, very skillful. comes up, hits the bell. Now he's turning, dipping the back end and trying to spin the boat round, but he's having problems. He's caught up in the eddy there.
And he was doing so well at the beginning of it. Don't forget, though, that last year, the winner of Paddles Up came from the junior heat, so we could be seeing some interesting paddling today. Some winning paddling.
Oh, he's a five there on the first pole, so now he's going over towards the finish and he's definitely got penalties.
Here we go, the paddle up, he's missed the top of that, so it's 2:36.04 and we add on 10 seconds for penalties. From Czechoslovakia for the second half of the junior heat, it's Wojciech Bareš, who was about 12 seconds behind the leader on the first one, but picked up about 10 seconds on penalties. He's powering away well down this little offshoot of the River Trent.
Yeah, the artificial slalom course here at Hope Pierpont. He's piling on the power down here. He's eased off because he came to the gate. Now he's got to get in there. Now there's only one person goes through from this hit. Oh, and he's made a mistake, dropped his paddles. He's having to sort himself out.
Hit himself with his paddle there. 5 seconds for missing the bell. There's another bell to be got now. Going across to the left-hand side. There he is. Very good.
Yeah, the winner of this heat goes through, and then it's the two fastest losers overall, and these guys are looking to beat 2:14.35 and 2:17.63, and I know Paul Ratcliffe's here hoping that they don't, really, because he's the next one and he's the defending Paddles Up champion.
So let's see how Wojciech Bareš does as he goes through the tunnel through six poles, and he's hit one, the other one's just bounced off as a result. Up goes the paddle, 2:32.23 with 10 seconds for penalties. Leo Hoare from Great Britain had a completely clean run on the first half of this heat and a good time as well, so he's got a bit of time to play with, but obviously he'll be doing the best he can to make sure he gets into the final. Got a little caught up there, John, in the waves.
Oh, and he's gone over trying to get the second boy there. He's got to keep the boat moving all the time. The art of slalom, I've said before, is to keep the boat moving, keep the plane moving. And the obstacles on this second half shouldn't prove any problem to them. It's just doing them as fast as possible.
I wonder if he managed that bell or not, but certainly there's determination on his face. He's getting in there. Yes, he did hit that bell. The other bell, though, he has missed. He's got to go round for it again, I think, although he will lose 5 seconds if he doesn't hit it. He's hit it, but I suspect he's added rather a lot of time. But remember, he did a good first run, so he's got a little bit of time to play with. We'll see what it comes out like at the end.
Yeah, passes his paddles through fairly cautiously. Now he's got to drive the boat over this flowing water here into this tunnel section, and he's doing very well. And if he keeps powering on, he could go into the lead.
Leo Hoare from Great Britain comes to the end. The paddle goes up, 2:35.52, and no seconds for penalties. He's in the lead. Matteo Pontarolo from Italy, a keen horse rider as well as canoeist, and in the first half of the heat, he made a clear run down with no penalties. He's hit that first red buoy successfully and the white one as well. This could be a very good run.
Yeah, he seemed to be going very well on that first sprint up to the stopper wave there, and looking determined as he comes down to this traditional slalom gate.
You can hear the crowd at the side of the river as he comes round into... he's got caught. He's missed the bell.
Yeah, in real trouble there. He approached the stopper rung and went at it, but it looks as though he's sorted himself out, and he's done very well to get back across there to hit that yellow buoy. Now he's into the stopper wave there, turning back on itself. He's riding it across to come back and hit the other bell.
So really lost 5 seconds on that first bell, but otherwise doing well. And of course, he did an excellent time in the first half of the heat. Yeah. He's got caught up. He's got caught up on the side. He's not going to be pleased at that.
No, he won't be pleased, but he's taking it steady. I think he realises that he's only got a 5 second penalty, so he's moving quite nicely now.
But he's hit. He's missed one of the poles.
He's disqualified. If you miss any section of the tunnel, you're disqualified, and that's it. He's out the event.
So up goes the paddle, but Matteo Pontarolo is out, disqualified. It all goes to show that anything can happen. This is James Croft from Great Britain, the fastest in the first half of the heat, and you can see why. John, you've been doing a little bit of calculations, I know.
Yeah, James is on the course, but we now know that Marianne Struttel and Radcliffe have gone through to the final, so James Croft coming down looking to win his heat. He won't beat those two times, I don't think, but if he does, he'll win his heat anyway and go through. So James is coming down. Are we going to see, though, a young lad go through to the final from the juniors and win as Paul Ratcliffe did last year?
He's doing well. He's steering himself well. He's going to go straight through that muncher, the bit that eats you up. But look at that bell. He's missed the bell. He tried. He tried so hard. He couldn't reach out far enough. He's going to get 5 seconds. He's gone into the bank now. I said anything could happen, and look at it.
He's having real problems here now. He's got to pass his paddles through. That's part of the rules, and he's done that. He's got to beat this 2:35, and although it looks as though he's got oceans of time, he needs to keep the boat moving.
Remember, he had such a good run first time round. He's got caught up a little bit there. He's going slow. Let's see how he does. For James Croft from Great Britain, up goes the paddle, 2:18.26. 5 seconds for penalties. He's in the final. So what a heat that was. We now know that James Croft from Great Britain will go into the final that time, 2:23.26. None of the others, though, were fast enough losers. So Leo Hoare from Great Britain, Wojciech Barras from Czechoslovakia, they're out, as are Dejan Kral from Slovenia and Keith O'Toole from Ireland, and Matteo Pontarolo from Italy, who was, of course, disqualified.
So as we saw just then, James Croft goes into the final, and James has joined me now. How actually did you find the course?
I found it very good. I enjoyed the moves and some new obstacles there, and it seemed to be very tricky, but it proved to be okay in the end.
Well, of course, the course was in two halves. Now, looking at the first half, which had the sausage roll, the Eskimo roll and all that, yeah. Perhaps you can take us through that. How did you find it?
Okay, well, the start off the slide, that was another obstacle which I haven't actually done before in Paddles Up, so in my last year, my first year. So I enjoyed that was very good. Good splash in there at the beginning. And then I was very quick around the posts, some very short strokes to get the speed up. And then to the football, a little bit of a problem, but I managed to flick it up and popped it into the raft. The sausage, or the roll, was one of my favourite, was a favourite because I'd put a lot of effort in and I was quite hot by that time.
That's so, where the speed really starts, yeah, of course, on that section.
Yeah, so like the good flat section, that was building up the speed. And then you came down to the balls, and there's a bit of jiggery-pokery and hitting them and missing one, the red one. And then the quoits in the mouth, couldn't really breathe, but I managed somehow. And the limbos, the second one was a bit of a problem. I had to go, like, get back for that one. And then the hitting the buoy with the front of the boat, that was all right. And then to the finish, so it's quite good.
You obviously have a very clear memory of it. Does it sort of get imprinted on your mind because of what you go through?
Yeah, there is a good mental rehearsal routine to go through before the race, and because you have no practice run, that's the mental rehearsal is crucial. And being so focused, you remember exactly what you do, and then you analyse and see where you went wrong.
Now, what about the second half of the heat? Because that involved more speed and it was more technical as well.
Yeah, a shorter course and more technical moves, and there was places to be gained to take the speed off here and there. Coming up through the big eddy at the start, through the first gate, over to the buoy. A lot of speed there to be taken off, to turn around for the second buoy, hit that, fine. Speed down to the second gate, onto the plug hole, we call it, and hit the bell. Good bit of balance manoeuvre there.
But you got caught up a little bit there, didn't you?
Yeah, after that, I got the bell fine, then I went down for the buoy and the bell, the second bell, and I went to go straight in and out of the stopper and came out too early and missed the next bell.
What's it like when you get that feeling that you're stuck and you're going to have to really pull yourself out?
You've really got to forget about that obstacle if you've missed it and go on to the next, you know, target or whatever, and concentrate and focus down to the next thing.
And how did the rest of the second half go?
I got a bit stuck at the life ring and the tunnel was a bit dodgy, but I managed to pull out in the end and get my paddles up.
What did you think about the competition you were up against?
Some top-class juniors, which I met earlier during the year, and I managed to do a good run and keep it together all the way down.
Well, of course, battling against juniors is one thing, but now you're into the final with the seniors, men, women, everybody. How's that going to be?
Yeah, I had a quick look at the list, and there's some medal winners, Olympic medal winners there, so I'll give it my all.
And, of course, there is a precedent of a junior doing rather well last year.
Last year, Paul did really well last year. And I'll see if I can keep up the junior tradition from last year and win again.
Well, thanks very much and good luck to you. Let's see who will indeed be joining you in the final. We have Ian Raspin, the winner of Heat 1. Also, Gareth Marriott, an Olympic silver medalist. Joachim Lettmann, an Olympic bronze medalist. Lukas Pollitt, Olympic champion. Lynn Simpson, the winner of the women's heat. Paul Ratcliffe, the defending paddles up champion, as we mentioned just then. And Marianne Strukel in yet another Paddles Up final. We'll see whether he'll win this year. Well, we'll find out in an exciting final, so join us for it.
And that grand final is tomorrow morning at the same time, 10:35, here on BBC One.
From Nottingham and the final of this year's Paddles Up. Now, it's hard to say what the competition's been like so far, except to say that we've had Olympic medalists disappearing out of the frame altogether, and we've had young hopefuls doing far better than surely they could ever have imagined. So who knows what's going to happen today? Well, John Gosling, who else? Any ideas?
Well, we've got five British paddlers through to the final, which is probably our best ever attendance in a final of Paddles Up. But from overseas, Strutel from Slovenia, he must be in with a chance, as Pollard, the C1 gold medalist from the Olympics. But Lettmann, the flying German, is probably the favourite, I would say. He was fastest in the heats, only by a second or so, but he's going really well and controlling the water.
Now, what about young Paul Radcliffe, the defending champion? He didn't even think he'd make it into the final. Well, he wasn't sure, but he's made it. Is he going to get through?
Well, he held it together on that second half of the heats. He was way down, and he did the fastest run of everyone down there, some 41 seconds. Only Raspin could touch him. The others were 7 seconds behind. So if the nerves are hold for him, then he's in with a good chance. But it's the nerves, that's it. And I hope so, but Lettmann, my money's on Lettmann.
OK, so the message is, hang on to your armchairs. This is the lineup for the final of Paddles Up.
Starting off with Lukáš Pollard from Czechoslovakia, the Olympic gold medalist for Canadian singles. From the British Olympic team, Lynn Simpson, winner of the women's heat. James Croft from Great Britain, the junior world champion and winner of the junior heat. Marianne Strupel, an Olympic paddler with a silver from the pre-Olympics, in the final as one of the fastest losers. Paul Radcliffe, the defending Paddles Up champion, just qualifying as the fastest loser. Gareth Marriott from Great Britain, an Olympic silver medalist, came second as well in the World Cup. Ian Raspin, also from Great Britain, the 1989 Paddles Up champion and winner of this year's Heat 1. And finally, Germany's Joachim Lettmann, the men's kayak bronze medalist from the 1992 Olympics, the fastest paddler in the competition so far. And off we go for the first half of the Paddles Up final. This is Lukáš Pollard from Czechoslovakia, and an unusual start to this final, John.
Yeah, he had to start 10 metres using his hands only, then takes his paddles from a holder, and now he drives into the fast-flowing water and down through a traditional slalom gate, which he does clear there, the two green and white poles. Spins out into the fast-flowing water now towards a kite.
A very choppy at the moment. He's going to pick up that kite. It's going to be very interesting to see what technique the paddlers use, because the next bit is to roll to an Eskimo roll and not lose that kite. And he's hung on to it. Going to deposit the kite on the left-hand side. The judges will confirm 5 seconds if he's missed that.
Yeah, that was a bad mistake. He should have gone further over, because he can't afford those five-second penalties there. He's spun round now, past his paddles, through the life buoy there. Now he comes down to a traditional upstream gate, red and white pole, turns into it very well indeed, see the C1 there, and drives across the flowing water to hit a yellow life buoy.
There it is, hitting the buoy there. Now you'll have noticed a bell just a second ago. That's what Lukáš Pollard is going to cross back to and hit it. And now it's a case of going down through a 14-pole zigzag tunnel.
That's right, here he is. It's really hard. The stopper wave there holding him in. And now he's fighting his way towards the finish.
The timing will stop when he goes through that final gate. Here we go, the timing for Lukáš Pollard, 1:19.02 with 5 seconds as penalties. A time to beat then of 1:24.02 for Lynn Simpson from Great Britain, the winner of the women's heat, and in fact the only woman in the final. Take it very cautiously, John. I suppose if you miss the paddle, you've lost the whole lot, really.
Yeah, she's having a real problem because she's so small. Lynn is determined to do well in this Paddles Up final. Talking to her just a few minutes before the event started, and she was looking at the course and she said, "Gozzy, I really want to get in there and be amongst the men." Comes down the kite. She had problems with the deposit of the kite in the heat, and she's collected that now. She's going to drive over and try and miss the stopper and come down this side. That's a good move now. She's got to drive over towards this deposit area. And has she done it? Oh, she threw it too soon. She's missed by miles.
A little too high up the river for that. Now the next obstacle, the next challenge to get the paddle through the life belt. Held up for just a moment there, but Lynn kept going. Lynn Simpson from Great Britain pushing hard on this one. Round she goes, the upstream gate, the red and white poles. Good control there, pushing through and now cutting across the river.
That's right now. Now she comes to the power moves, and this is where Lynn has to work harder than the men, because obviously she isn't as strong as the men. She hits that very well, waits to hit the stop away. Now she's got to drive across and she's missed the bell. She's going to be so upset. The water was just too powerful for her and has dragged her downstream, so she's collecting penalties and having problems now.
Straight into this zigzag 14-pole tunnel. Hits any of these, it's 5 seconds. If she misses any, more penalty points. But there she goes, 1:21.32 with 10 seconds as penalties. So Lukasz Pollet still in the lead, but only just. And remember, this is just the first half of the final. This is James Croft from Great Britain reaching for his paddle and pulling round now for the first gate, the downstream gate, through the green and white poles. And the next job is to pick up that quoit.
Yeah, James moving very well indeed. He's moving down towards the quoit. He's got to be steady. Now he's got to do this roll gate. He's holding the quoit in his hand. He hasn't gone for the mouth. And now he's got the flick over. Now he's much closer than anyone else. I think he might do it. Oh, and he throws it just too hard. He's down the side of the stopper, so he's saving time now as he comes down to pass his paddles through this live buoy. Steady now, nicely there, James. Now he's got the right-hand breakout. He's moving very well indeed here.
So round he goes, pulls up between the poles. He's a little slow, he's a little close, but he's made it through. Now, there's a lot of zigzagging on this course, isn't there, John? Because next it's across the yellow buoy and then back for the bell.
Yeah, he's done a slightly different move there. He does it in reverse, comes over, hits the bell very well indeed here now, and he's got to drive down through this last part, and he's always held up in the stopper holding him there, but he's heading down towards the finish.
14 poles, 7 gates. Will he hit any of them? This is James Croft from Great Britain doing a good time. 107.74 with 5 seconds for penalties. For now, he's in the lead. So let's see what Marian Strukel, a 27-year-old from Slovenia, can do. Got a silver in the pre-Olympics, a very powerful paddler. So hopefully, John, we should get good speed on this one.
Yeah, and the hole. Oh, and he collects a 5 right at the start. Too high. He just flew out of that stopper. He doesn't know whether he's gone through the gate, so he's come round again, having problems at the start. And the final goes in reverse order of the heat qualifying time. So although he qualified as the fastest loser, or one of the fastest losers, he's still quite high on the ranking now. He's done the roll. He's having problems because he came up. Oh, Strudel's in trouble rolling. He could be having real problems here. He could be out. Oh, he'll be so upset about that. He's missed that. He's disorientated. He's going to try a lob from the back. God knows what's that. Oh, and there it is, missed by a long way. He needs to pass his paddles through, but he's having real problems here, Michael.
So through the life belt he goes, and if he can just work out what he's got to do next, then, well, we'll see what his timing's like. Just coming up to 1 minute now as he goes round for the upstream gate, pulling himself round. Now, remember, Marian Strukel has good power, so if he can pick up the speed, he might do all right.
Yeah, the biggest problem is these paddlers rolling at this time of the day. It's very early in the morning, really, and it's cold, and they're going for it now, and he hits that bell, and he's moving down, and he's going to power on down, and he'll keep going right to the end.
Great shame, though, because his timing now, unfortunately, is a little too far gone. Let's see what the final time is as he comes through the final gate. For Marian Strukel, it's 1:27.72 with 10 seconds for penalties. Now, watch this one. Just watch this. This is the defending Paddles Up champion, Paul Ratcliffe, 18 years old, from Great Britain. And the pressure is on him. And I think, John, if nerves don't get in the way of him, he could do very successfully.
Yeah, he's so pleased to be in the final. He thought he'd blown it in the heat when he had to qualify as the fastest loser. But he's coming down now, picks up the quoit, determination on his face, trying to keep out that stopper area. Rolling. Oh, he's slow on his roll as well, but he's very close to that. Can he get that quoit in? Yes, he's done it! He's caught himself in the stopper, but he's moving on now. Paul doing really well indeed.
Well done. If he was slowed down as he went under that Eskimo roll, as he went under the sausage roll, then I'm sure his confidence will have come back because he deposited that quoit. Moving across the river now for the upstream gate, pulling himself out. Look at that. Look at that. The paddle's going in and pulling himself right across the river now for first the yellow buoy and then the bell.
Yeah, he's hit the buoy now. He's got to drive very hard. Now if he can do it. Oh, and he has to second attempt at the bell. Now he's got these 14 poles, every one of them live. He can pick up penalties. He's got to keep going. He's got to keep going.
This is good style. It's good timing. It's Paul Ratcliffe, the defending champion from Great Britain. We have a clear run, do we? And a time of 109.94. Paul's in the lead. These runs in this Paddles Up final are getting faster and faster. This is Gareth Marriott from Great Britain, former junior world champion. He's picked up his paddle and there he goes for the downstream gate, but he's hit a pole 5 seconds already.
Yeah, Gareth won't be pleased with that at all. He clipped the first gate, but moving on down, he's got to collect this quoit. Now, he can get over to this side, which is what he's doing now. For a roll, he'll be up. Now, he'll definitely try and deposit this quoit because he's got the advantage of being a C1 paddler. Oh, no, it just clipped over the far side. He won't even know it isn't in.
It looks so easy and so effortless. Well, the life belt did look easy and effortless. That was superb. Through the life belt with the paddle and over for the upstream gate.
Yeah, we should see some fast moving here from Gareth. He should be over, dip the back end down now, and spins straight out. Look, watch him go now. Leans back, hits the buoy. One move, not even near the stopper, hits the bell. Turns the boat again now. He's really moving on his home water here. He knows every inch of this Nottingham course.
Look at this silver medalist from the Olympics. Such control as he goes through the 14-hole zigzag tunnel down towards the end where the clock will stop. It's very close. It's 1:10:12 with 10 seconds for penalties for Gareth Marriott. Another British paddler, Ian Raspin, pushing hard. Look at those arms going round and round, pushing hard. Up he goes for the paddle off the suspended wire and now round for the downstream gate. He's going a little out to the right, but maybe that's to get his a good curve round. Getting a little caught up in the waves there, John.
Yeah, that's right. He went too far and he's had a problem already. Raspin won't be pleased about that. And to be honest, this new start idea was one of Ian Raspin's ideas for paddles up, so I won't say he's been practising it, but it's certainly a great idea. Now he's got the quoit in his mouth. He's going for the roll. He's angled his boat so he can drive over towards the deposit in the quoit, and very cleverly done. He's prepared to lose a few seconds on that to save the five-second penalty.
That is obviously the way to do it. I wonder if other paddlers watching from the banks will come down sideways with their canoes as well.
Well, you see, there's so few left to go now, but Raspin coming down with this right-hand breaker. He knows what Ratcliffe's done, so he knows he's got to beat 110, really, or 109. So he's moving on down. He knows he's got to do a clear run. He's taking his time, probably being a bit too cautious, Raspin, here.
The time at the moment, 1:01. He's got 1:09 to beat. Ian Raspin from Great Britain coming down now for the final poles.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to beat... Well, he's definitely not going to beat Paul's time, but he's got to keep it clean now on these poles as he drives down towards the finish.
Remember, there is, of course, another half of the heat to go of the final. It's 1:15:44 with no seconds for penalties. So what tips will Jochen Lettmann from Germany have picked up by watching the other paddlers? We will see. Now, we had the fastest time off this man in the heat. So, John, we'll see how he does now.
Yeah, I mean, he was most unhappy about having to roll. And he was saying, I don't mind anything on the course, but the roll gate I'm not happy about. He's concentrating as he comes down now towards this roll. And he knows he's got to do the course clear, really.
We thought we'd have some disasters with the quoits on that roll. A few people letting them go underneath, but not so, it seems. Yes, the quoit goes in very nicely.
Yeah, and he misses the stopper there. So he's doing a very good run here. He's always caught up a little bit there and slowing himself down. He's got to keep the boat moving. Remember, 109.94 is Paul Ratcliffe, but in second place at the moment is James Croft, the junior. So it's really the younger boys are showing these older paddlers all about paddles up.
And that indeed is what happened last year as well. Speed is all important. He's managed the buoy. He's fighting for the bell. He's lost the bell. That's 5 seconds for Jochen Lettmann. Very, very annoying for him. 14 poles. It's a 7-gate zigzag tunnel. The poles are different distances apart. Let's see how he can do it as he comes through the final gate. The time 1:09:20, but 5 seconds as penalties. So here we are at the end of the first half of the final. Paul Ratcliffe, the defending paddles up champion from Great Britain. He will be surprised to see himself in the lead, but there he is. James Croft from Great Britain following on 3 seconds behind, 1:12:74. Jochen Lettmann, who actually did the fastest run from Germany but got held back on penalties, 1:14:20. Ian Raspin from Great Britain in fourth place. Gareth Marriott, also from Great Britain, in fifth place, followed by Lukasz Pollert from Czechoslovakia, Lynn Simpson from Great Britain, and Marianne Strukel from Slovenia. But that's just the first half of the final. Let's have a look at the second half. And here's Marianne Strukel from Slovenia, who's been in the final for the last 3 years, but not successfully yet. Here's a new part of the course, a red boy, a white boy, and a yellow boy to start with.
That's right, and now a totally new inventive thing for paddles up, the C1 section. Kayak paddlers have had to nominate left or right blade. They've all nominated right, and they have a green gate, a red pole, and a green gate to go through, and they can only use the right-hand blade, otherwise there's penalties, but he was very successful through that.
I think we'll see some fun on that with other competitors. Down he comes. Now, Marianne Strukel now going to reach up for that yellow plaque hanging under the bridge, and now the next... Oh, that's that pink boy should have been hit by his canoe.
That's right. He should have hit that with the boat, and he was offline, so he's missed that. So he's picked up a five-second penalty. He rings the bell and now drives down to these three limbos before the paddles up. Through the limbo, hits the stopper, stops him. Through the next limbo and drives on down.
And coming up to the final line, let's see the time for Strukel. It's 2:28, 2:29:37, and 5 seconds for penalties. Lynn Simpson from Great Britain has a time of 2:34:37 to beat now. But remember, that's the time for the two heats put together. No worries so far. Lynn said to me that she was determined to get to the final, and if she got to the final, she would win. It's a brave hope. She seems to be being pulled sideways, or has been. Now goes down into this section where she has to paddle Canadian style. They are, the right paddle is in the water. She can swap sides of the boat, but it has to be the right paddle all the time. She goes round that upstream pole. She's hit it. That's 5 seconds. She goes through the downstream gate and back onto both paddles.
Yeah, she did really well there. You could see she was struggling. It's a hard manoeuvre for the kayaks. But she's coming down now. She's got this target, which is very hard for her. Does it very well now. Can she get this buoy? Shrivel was completely offline for it. She's done it. I think she hit that really well there. She's done a tremendous job. She's having to back ferry glide across the water. They're driving about. Hits the bell. Now she'll drive down. And this stopper, this first stopper on this limbo could be a problem.
Watch for the sign. Danger, fast water. There it says it. This is where it gets fast. Under the first limbo, there's two more to come. She's trying to control herself. She's gone under the second one. This is looking good. We have a... Oh, she's hit the third. What a shame. She's picked up 5 points on that. That's an awful shame. For Lynn Simpson, 235.42 and 15 penalty points. Lukasz Pollet from Czechoslovakia said to me the course is fun and he has no worries either way. But let's see, he could win this. We'll see how it goes. He's hit two suspended buoys at the moment and a third one. Now, this is the bit where a Canadian paddler really comes into his own.
That's right. He should, well, this is his section, so flies round. Look at that, how fast he's into there. Straight round, straight out. He's on the right side for him, so that's tremendous.
What's actually happening to his paddle? He seems to be twisting it round as he goes down. He
manoeuvres it underwater to spin the boat. The central spinning point on a C1 is very good, and he hits that. Now, he should have no problem at all with the ball here as he comes down. This big orange boy, he hits it no problem through the stop of the wave that holds him there, driving down now towards the bell. He's slightly offline, but now he's driving down to these limbos, and we should see some interesting moves by these C1s on this.
And I think doing a very good time. He's a little higher here. Oh, he's gone over, but pulled himself round. Maybe lost no time, but he's missed a limbo. He's gone over again. He's in bad trouble. He's missed a third limbo. This is not good. He's going to be very, very annoyed at that. Lukasz Pollet, up goes the paddle, 222.20, but he is disqualified. Anything can happen and is happening in this paddles up final. This is Gareth Marriott from Great Britain pushing hard, hits the boys, the suspended boys very well. And again, another Canadian style paddler kneeling is in his canoe, has just that one paddle, so should pull round these poles and gates very well.
Yeah, very deep strokes there. Gareth moving on down really well. He's driving his boat down and he's really pleased to see a C1 section in this. He's one of the best paddlers in the world, and he's very keen on paddles up and promoting it.
He says his hobbies are canoeing, sleeping and eating. I think just canoeing on his mind at this moment. Oh, yes, well done. Just glances off that boy and pushes down now for the bell. He hits that. What timing's good, John.
Yeah, he's going very well indeed. The determination on his face. He knows he's got to be steady on these limbos. He's having problems there. Holds the boat really well. Goes under the second. Coming to the third. This is a very good time here, Michael.
This is Gareth Marriott from Great Britain. Up goes the paddle any second now. The time, 2:11.43. No seconds of penalties. He's well in the lead. The 1989 Paddles Up champion. This is Ian Raspin from Great Britain, a member of Tees Kayak Club. He has hit one, two, and in a moment, three. I'm sure he will. The third boy just now. Again, we're back to a kayak having to paddle as
he made a mistake there. He put a blade stroke in, so he's got a 5 second penalty. Raspin will be so annoyed with himself. He just did it naturally and forgot about the section. I'm sure
it must be so easy to do that, because that's the way he's used to paddling.
He didn't even use the stroke. It wasn't a power stroke or anything. It was just a natural move. So anyway, Raspin's on his way down. Oh, and I think he's gone so fast he's missed the ball. Oh, he will be so disappointed.
Mind you, he is doing, his speed is good, and remember, his speed in the first half of the final was good. So if he loses a little bit now, it might not matter, but I think he's out of this now. This is Ian Raspin. He's going under the third limbo gate. Coming up to the final, up goes the paddle any second. It's 2:08.47 and 10 seconds as penalties. What a way this final is going. There is just no telling what will happen next. This is Jochen Lettmann from Germany coming down to those first three boys. They actually look fairly easy. It's a fairly easy way to start the final.
Well, yeah, but nothing's easy in the final of paddles up. Now, Lettmann now down. He's moving his blade, but he's not hitting the water, so he's OK. He's gone round that C1 section. He's through it, so he's OK. He's moving on down now. Lettmann, it was my favourite at the start, but Radcliffe proved something tremendous, pulled it, but... He's coming on down now. He's got to go through this stopper and hit this target. Done that very well indeed.
That's nice. As long as you've got the height, you should be able to get that. Now, has he got that? He may have glanced it, but it looks like... Well, I'm not sure on that one.
Well, he's hit the bell and he's moving on down now, but...
So apparently he did get that boy. So we're all right on that now.
He's taking this a bit cautious, Michael. He's got stuck in the stopper. He's losing time. He needs to move on.
This could be very close. He's hit one limbo. That is going to be so annoying. Up goes his paddle. Let's see the time. 207.23, 5 seconds of penalty points. Just missed the lead. And that's the way this paddles up final is going. It is so close. This is James Croft from Great Britain. One of his aims, he said, was to actually send those hanging boys spinning. I think at this moment in the second half of the final, his mind will not be on little tactics like that, but simply on getting round, getting a good speed, and getting through those gates around the obstacles. Look at that, the right paddle only he can use as he goes round that upstream pole, then through the downstream gate, the green one, the downstream, he's got through very clearly. Both paddles go in, and he's getting up a bit of speed now.
Yeah, he looks much happier now. He looked very tense as he went down those first three boys, but he's looking a bit happier now. I think if he hits his boy, he'll be really happy. If he doesn't, he'll fly. And he hit that, so now he's through that stopper, driving down, he's clear up to now. He's got the bell. This is so interesting. It's the C1 result of Gareth Marriott. They've got a beat, but now James coming down. Look at the tension on his face.
This is a very good time, but he's gone backwards. Has he, did he get under that? He's turned over. He's hit the limbo. This is bad news for James Croft. Look at his face. He's annoyed. That final time, 206.80 and 10 seconds as penalties. This 18-year-old lad must be so nervous. You can see it on his face. Paul Ratcliffe from Great Britain, he is the defending paddles up champion. And at this moment, we simply don't know whether he's going to win or not. He's doing, he's steady. He's steady to start with. He's obviously determined. He is not going to hit anything. In that paddle goes. Remember, it's the right-hand paddle only as you go through that section. Now with both, he picks up the speed.
He looks happier now, but he looks so tense. And this is the worrying thing. If he takes it too cautiously, he could blow it. The time he's got to beat is a C1. Gareth Marriott, tremendous performance. Hit this ball. He's hit the ball. He's moving down. Is he going to do it? I don't know. The limbo is such a difficult section on this course. Paul's moving down clear at the moment. Look at the determination on his face. He's going to drive through that first limbo. Get through it. He's moving on down.
He's totally clear. He's got no penalty points so far. He's coming up. He could win. He's going to win. Up goes the paddle. That is Paul Ratcliffe with a time of 2 minutes and almost 1 second.
What a performance. That is unbelievable. To retain it at his age, under the pressure he's been under, that is absolutely fantastic.
Last year's Paddles Up champion becomes this year's Paddles Up champion as well. And there we have it, confirmation of Paul Ratcliffe from Great Britain having won, 2 minutes, 0.50 seconds. Gareth Marriott, well behind him from Great Britain, 2 minutes, 11.43 seconds. Jochen Lettmann from Germany, 2.12.23. James Croft from Great Britain, 2.16.80. Ian Raspin from Great Britain at 2.18.47. And then Marianne Strugel from Slovenia, Lynn Simpson from Great Britain, and Lukas Pollitt from Czechoslovakia, who was disqualified for missing a limbo.
Well, what an exciting final, and what an exciting competition. The competitors have been battling it out for the prestige of winning Paddles Up, and also for the Norwich Union Trophy. Well, here to present that trophy is Reg Sear from Norwich Union.
Hello.
And the person who's going to get it is the defending champion from last year, Paul Ratcliffe.
Well done, indeed. Congratulations.
Well, Paul, well done. Did you enjoy the final?
Yeah, it was a tremendous final. It was really close at dinner time, and I knew I had to pull a good run out to take the title again.
Now, you were nervous, weren't you?
I was yesterday. I was a little bit shaky going for the ball and through the limbo gates, so it weren't too good on.
And you were saying to me yesterday that if you could overcome those nerves, maybe you could do it, and you did, so you obviously conquered them.
Yeah, I knew if I could have a good run, then I had a good chance of winning again.
Now, what are you going to be doing with this decanter? Because you've got one from last year. I gather it's on the mantelpiece of your parents' home near Manchester. Is this going to join it?
Yeah, I think this is going to go alongside it in my parents' house again.
Well done, and thanks very much. And thanks also to John Gosling for his help with the commentary in Paddles Up. I hope you've enjoyed the series. If you'd like to give canoeing a go yourself, well, why not? Pop down to your local sports centre or contact the British Canoe Union here at the National Water Sports Centre in Nottingham. That's it for Paddles Up for this year. So from all of us, bye-bye.
Richard Fox has been world slalom canoeing champion on four occasions during the course of the 80s. He's been